it going? My name is Scott Wichmann. I'm your new, well, I'm your new owner. Talking to a camcorder right now, but I'm your new owner. It's fantastic. It's Christmas, Christmas Eve. Now it's Christmas Day. It's 1:31 a.m. Christmas morning. I've just gotten this camcorder for my mom. It's an amazing gift. I can't believe she did it. I can't believe she went through with it and bought this, but it's mine. I'm going to use it to my best of my imaginative ability. So basically, I guess I'm your host forever. Well, this is me. This is my room, my surroundings, and we're pretty much just beginning. I'm going to, you know, show you a lot of things. Basically, you know, around the house, because there's, you know, there's no Steve-O or Chuck or anybody right now here that we can go knock things over with. No Bill Methvin to ride the roof of a car. So I guess it's just going to be pretty boring for a little bit until I get the knack of using this camera. But it's going to be, you know, it should be pretty fun. Tomorrow, or later on today, should I say, you know, we'll go visit the family. We'll show you some of the sights around scenic Pittsfield. We'll see all the different family members, and we'll do lots of neat stuff, and then hopefully eventually later on this tape, I'll be able to take you to the wilds of northeastern Pennsylvania and, you know, show you what goes on there as I race some hell with my best friend Danny Walker. But without further ado, I'll show you some of the sights around here, just this basic area, my room, 24 Joseph Drive, my dad's house. Nice place, pretty cool. Got some pretty interesting things here. Maybe we'll take a couple strolls or two down memory lane. I'm just getting the knack of using this thing here. Let's zoom in. Let's just, I wonder how close we can get, but still keeping this thing in focus. Whoa! Okay, now let's back up. I really have no clue what's going on here, but I'm doing it anyway. Should be pretty fun. And, you know, if you haven't emptied the contents of a shotgun into your head by now, I know you're still with me. So, but we'll take a look around the room.
Lots of Larry Bird stuff got here. Here's my hero. As you can tell, probably, that America's Team thing was given to me by Greg McTeague, who's now my roommate. Gave it to me last year. Larry Bird, pretty big and inspirational force in me. Kind of a hero of mine. You can probably tell. Yep. Just show you a little bit of this corner here. This corner of the room is pretty much filled with Larry Bird stuff. I'm trying to move this chair out of the way. Yep, there it is. Big, huge Larry Bird picture. Yeah. He's my man, my homie. Let's get a look at that cheesy grin. There he is. How's it going, you hick from French Lick?
Oh, pretty good.
That t-shirt there I wore. Oh, geez, I don't know what grade that is. Fifth, sixth? Something like that. It's a pretty small one. But, it's not small at all when you compare it to one you're going to see in a second. There's Larry in the Wheaties box, whatever. Larry's jersey. There's what I'm talking about. Check out the size of that. Well, you're probably getting it's not actual size, but take a look at that. In comparison to that jersey, take a look at the size of that shirt. Wore that when I was about 3 years old. Big Red Sox fan, too. Yeah, there's Indiana Jones. He's hanging out. Pretty nice guy. Notice the 3D glasses. Got those at Potsdam, New York Pizza Hut in 1991. Pretty interesting. No, 1992. Pardon me. Didn't mean to get my dates mixed up. Those are your plan at home. There's the Punisher, Silver Surfer, Ghost Rider. You know, nice little quiet bunch. There's Dark Lord of the Sith, Darth Vader, and his counterpart. Yoda, how's it going, big guy?
Oh, yes, right.
Well, whatever. And if you move past the beer glass, you'll catch my grandfather, him and Yoda, hanging out, having a couple beers, as you can tell. See, it's empty. It's empty. That glass, by the way, was given to me by Megan Hudson. Fine young lady out of Illinois. There's Luke Skywalker. A couple Christmas cards. Irish Spring. I'm getting payola for that one. Yeah, E.T., he wanted to phone home and stuff like that, but what the hell. You know. Oh, my cord's getting stretched out here, but what the hell. Got some nice glasses down here. Wade Boggs, Red Sox third baseman. Grandparents, always nice. Yeah, there's the good old Roger Clemens shrine. I made that in a wood shop in the 8th grade, that Red Sox 21 thing. I don't know if you can see this or not, but he actually signed this card. There it is, see? Roger Clemens, signed by the man himself. Pretty big time. And down here are quite a few of my pictures of high school things. There's an apple that Rita Julius gave me for 1,000 clowns. My basketball letter from Lackawanna Trail. There you can see that little indicator light flashing in the picture. That's my Madrigal picture. That is the man, Danny Walker. That's Danny Walker at the ripe young age of, oh God, say 14, 13, something like that. There he is as a junior in high school. Big difference, huh? Danny, right in the middle there is Danny again. No, wait, give me focus. Me and Danny sitting like little bums. That's a Twizzler in my mouth if you're wondering what's going on. There, see that girl right there, right next to me? That girl too, well, it'd be my right, your left. That's, what the hell's her name? Oh, shit, I forgot her name. One of the Lynch sisters, something like that. Adrian? Yeah, I'll say Adrian, yeah. She was, well, involved me, a long choir trip in the back of a bus. Forget it, it's too long a story, but there's Danny Walker. There. We have a couple merit awards for running. Nice little most musical freshman, big deal. And now we take a deep, dark look into the closet. Lots of shoes. Big Reebok guy. This guy, 2 pairs of Reeboks. Check it out. Softball bat, boxing glove. You know. Nice wardrobe. Boy, he's got it going on. And, you know, basketball, my favorite sport. I like the way they dribble up and down the court. Like to... Hey, there they are again. Danny and Scott, oh, see, baseball's MVP? That was me. That was the man. This camera's probably bouncing and jiggling like crazy. I'm gonna get in here and show you something for a second. I'll be right back. Here we are, the Red Sox Chronicles. Herein contained is so much Red Sox paraphernalia, it'll make you sick. Couple of great names, Tony Armas, Nick Asaski. Wrote a lot of names of guys. News clips, comments, and The Fortunes of the Beantown Bombers by Scott Wichmann. And many journalists and photographers, Bruce Hurst. Took a minor league contract. Yeah, you know, I was really big into the Bo Sox. Yeah, what do we got? Yeah, Red Sox Chronicles, Dwight Evans, Dewey Rules. What the hell I'm showing you this for. Couple things I got had here. That's all about me. That's all about Scranton Theater. There we go. That wonderful year of 1986. Boy, there's Al Nipper going down. Dwight Gooden, Roger Clemens. It says, Dewey homered off Jack Morris on the first pitch of the season in Detroit. That he sure did. There they are going crazy. Wish I could recapture some of those moments, man. 86 AL champs. Went through that whole World Series thing. And, you know. Johnny Mack, he's out, he's fired, he's gone. See you later. Oh, excuse me, Spike Owen. Red Sox banking on Clemens, the whole deal. Yeah, he was my man. Definitely, that's Roger. Yeah, I won't make you endure this whole thing, but I got Cy Young Awards and everything here. He was definitely my boy, Roger Clemens. Check him out, man. He had the May 88 Rocket Man pitch back-to-back three-hit shutouts. Yeah. All penned by yours truly, right here. Hey, he's right in the mirror up there, if you just take a look. How's it going? Hi, how are you? Yeah. Everything's backwards in the mirror, check it out. Now let's get back to our story here. Got Roger Clemens, the Rocket Man. There he is. Check that out. First pitch of the 88 season, popped up by Tony Phillips. Remember it. There'll be a short quiz later. Picture of some Brewer guy getting struck out by the Rocket. He's definitely the man. There he is, look at the power in that pitcher. He's the greatest. Yeah, Morgan's miracle. Boston Red Sox, Boston Red Sox. There's a pretty good thing in here about Roger. Something I put together. Here's the time they won 13 in a row. Yeah, Clemens. One hitter against the new tribe, broken up by Dave Clark in the H. Never forget that moment. Heart was in my throat. Yeah, Red Sox. 1978. Big time. Remember that. Boston Red Sox send the New York Yankees packing. Yankees go home. Opening day ticket from 84. Shouldn't even be in here because this is the 88 season, but it doesn't matter. Clemens blanks the Yanks. Win the AL East. Do basically what every Red Sox team does, get swept by Oakland. Hey, that's the way. Go four and out, Bruce Hurst history. 89 season, we're gone. Look, Nolan Ryan, check this out. This is great. This is some for the ages right here. Says headline says, today it's Heat versus Heat. Clemens takes on Ryan for the first time. Rocket. Nolan Ryan. He won that one 2-1 on a home run by Rafael Palmeiro. You know, the crybaby. And then Clemens won the second shutout. Their second shutout with Ryan, 7-6. Remember winning that one because that was the night I rented clean and sober for the first time. Yeah, Red Sox 1990. Sox beat the Jays, Clemens wins 10th, Romine hits one out. Great year that was. Here's a good picture of the boy, right there. Let's see if we can get that in focus. Clemens rolls the Sox. See, he's definitely the man. You can't argue with that. There he is, again. Clemens and Oakland jinx. Jeez, if he knew I had this freaking thing. Clemens beats the Jays, 1-0. There it is, right there. There's my man. The best. Sox rally in the ninth for 7 straight. Sox are looking to Roger Clemens to win him the AL East title. In terms of control and dominance, he might go down as the greatest pitcher who ever lived. Number one forever. The big gun. The best. King of the Hill. Rocket Man. Top of the heap. Boy, I made this stuff when I was about, oh geez, 11th grade. Something like that. Surprised I was still into baseball that much. Canseco, Clemens. I always thought the Rocket was the best. Still is. Canseco, you suck. Can't put him into pitch against the Red Sox on here. Stupid. Clemens, boost from the Rocket. Yeah, you know. The Red Sox definitely got it going on. Rocket revival. Yeah. So we still gotta, you know, couple years to go, fill this thing up, but got a lot of things going on here, so now that I've bored you with that. Alright, and cut into Spider-Man, too. He's definitely my boy. Check that out, it's great. Great little section in here. I'm gonna show it to you. Spider-Man boy, he's definitely awesome. Number one with a bullet. He doesn't want to kill anyone. That's his big thing. Ninja Turtles. Get them out of here. Not this guy's gonna get pulled over for having a gun underneath his jacket. Ooh, that's 80. Spider-Man. Spider-Man beats the crap out of this one guy. There he is, right there. Check that out. That's awesome. Spider-Man gets pissed off. Oh man, wham! Let's this guy have it. Boy, oh boy. Yeah, and then he gets, you know, this thing blows up behind him. Spider-Man takes everybody on here. Does a nice little job on this guy here. You know, shoots him with the web. Right, see? Don't hear that sound? Sound of the beat. Hits behind him. He says, ooh, you missed. And he goes, jeez. Oh, shit. You guys really ought to get out more. At least your local video store, might I suggest. Batman Returns. Isn't that funny? Oh, boy. Yeah, Spider-Man kicks the shit out of everybody. After your father's death, you were orphaned. You were 10 years old. You went to live with your cousin on a sheep and horse ranch in Montana. And... I don't know, Doctor. Tell me who decapitated your patient. Oh, good things to those who wait. Isn't that great? A great watch. We can do the same thing with Batman. Hold on, wait.
Kill you. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to tell all your friends about me.
What are you?
Oh yeah, I'm Batman, right?
Big Spider-Man fan, right? I got the three posters, and I got this huge stack of comic books going on here, but you gotta see this. Here we go. Check this out, check this out. See if I back this up a little bit. Look at that. Check that out here. We'll put it down on the bed here for you. Take a look. Holy shit. Spider-Man costume from sixth grade or so. Whew. Man, look at the eye holes and everything. Hey, I had it close enough to that guy. He had nothing on me. See, this is the best part. Check out right... Where are they? Yeah, right there. Right underneath his armpit. See? Check those out right there. Gotcha. I got you covered. Check this out right here. Oh boy, yeah. He got the web too. That was really awesome. Those are full of looms or something. Spider-Man. My costume was the best. As you can tell, I'm pretty much into costumes and stuff, you know. What with the two Batman masks and all, and the huge Batman noggin on my wall. But, yeah, I'm still into the Rocket, Roger Clemens. Check him out. Roger, over and out.
Into the hangar as Han tried desperately to start the Falcon's engines.
Here's my creation, Captain Courage. Made him, oh geez, let me think. How old was I? Otherworld Comics presents Captain Courage, leader of the Justice Revolution, right? Made him in fourth grade. Fifth. I remember I was in Mr. Oglesby's math class, obviously fooling around something. And idea just struck me. Why don't we combine a guy who looks like Captain Britain, Spider-Man, and Daredevil? See, he's got the little Daredevil thing, he's got the Spider-Man eyes, he's got the Captain Britain thing. He doesn't look noble. It's like, I'm gonna kick some butt, right? See, he's got this, got all this neat little logo, kind of looks like. Ooh, what's that? Ooh. Wow. Jesus Christ. There's a Rocketeer. This place is full of superheroes. Look at that. Hey, who's that? My boy. Spidey. Captain Britain. Captain Marvel. Daredevil. Thor. Yeah, this place is chock full of superheroes. You can't... There's lousy with superheroes. You just keep bumping into one. Thor taking on a dragon, right? Well, we'll be right back.
Just as I said, I'm just trying to learn how to use this thing and, you know, just bounce around the room a little bit and just show, you know, some of the things that make me tick. I don't know, I'd like to thank a couple people. First, I'd like to thank, Jesus for being born, for one reason, for one thing, you know, because this is one of the best Christmases I've had in a long time. And not just in terms of gifts, I mean, no, I just felt pretty positive tonight. I didn't know where it came from. thank my mom and my dad. And that's probably about it. I have to thank those two. My grandparents, too. I don't know. There are a lot of things to say. But, I know I'm gonna have fun using this thing. And, yeah. Well, I'll get on to something else. I got Shakespeare's sonnet here for you. There we go. Like as the waves make towards the pebbled shore, so do our minutes hasten to their end. Each changing pace with that which goes before, in sequent toil all forwards do contend. Nativity, once in the mane of light, crawls to maturity, wherewith being crowned, crooked eclipses gainst his glory fight, and time that gave doth now his gift confound. Time.
Hey, Dad.
What way?
That way.
Ooh.
Don't drop me. Put me back up.
Too heavy.
Please.
Too heavy.
Hey, Ashley. Say hi.
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 I need a picture. Run over and smile.
No!
Yeah.
Run over and smile. Hurry up.
No!
Let's smile.
No! Now he's going to have you just screaming on that thing.
Get me up. Daddy.
What do you watch? Ooh, the phone. Just a moment.
Oh, the jingle!
Wow. Oh no, we've got a derailment. I'm not sure, but it looks like hundreds of lives may have been lost in this one. Late-breaking story. If you just joined us late, derailment on the Main State product train line there in the New Haven, and it looks like... There's at least four people dead underneath the oppressive weight of that boxcar. Back to you, Bob. Come here and say something to me.
I want to talk to him.
No!
Yeah.
And then he'll show you on TV.
Come on, I'll show you on TV in a couple minutes.
Okay.
Sing him a song.
Sing me a song or something.
We'll put this back together and then we'll go up there and watch the train taking a wreck.
Yeah, serious.
Come on.
Oh, I see the problem. There was the cobwebs here.
You're a shy little one, aren't you?
Say your ABCs.
No. I don't want to sing.
Alright, why not? You'll be on TV.
What?
You want to be on TV?
You want to be on TV?
You'll be on TV, watch. Or we'll go upstairs, you'll be on TV.
Yeah. Oh, he's going to try this again.
Oh, Dad, he's going to run it into the roundhouse. This business of showing wrecks on the TV or...
That was awesome.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That was awesome. Here comes the train. Ted Wichmann is the engineer, ladies and gentlemen.
Ah!
And it looks like we may have another one. Another wreck, is it? I don't know, Bob. I can't really tell. Looks like, I skipped the track when I was trying to make the change.
Dad, can we go upstairs?
In a second, after the train goes to bed.
Yeah, the train's going to bed.
Here's the up.
See the train?
Here it comes. This is like an episode of Mr. Rogers here. Jesus. Just a minute. Hold on. In the truth, it is in there. Someone's got to close the doors. Good work.
Show them inside the roundhouse in the back here. I got
here
the lights
on. The inside. Now looking at, ladies and gentlemen, the inside of the Wichmann Roundhouse. Notice the real electric lights. all made by Ted Wichmann himself. Amazing but true? Yes. There, let's see if I can focus on it. There go the lights. And the trains are going to sleep. And we'll be back. Here we're looking at the long-lost sister that we see just about, oh, I guess once a year, maybe. There's the long-lost red flannel shirt that Dad just got from her. What'd you get, Steph? Show us, and here she is, the moment of truth, ladies and gentlemen, unwrapping the circular gift. It is totally tubular. Whoa!
Thanks. Mine broke.
Really?
She's got a Boy Scout flashlight.
That's small enough to fit in your purse, so that, you know, if you're going out at night, you've got a light.
Yeah.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
State of the art. Stephanie gets a lightsaber, Dad?
No, it's not a lightsaber. It's a lifesaver, not a lifesaver.
A lightsaber.
Lightsaber.
See how many we can stick on her. Going nuts with this camera, man.
You know, he's not gonna have any tape about by the time he gets over
there. I am too.
Sandy and Bob.
I got an hour and a half on this thing. Okay, Steph, tell us what it is.
It's a soft spun knit hooded scarf.
Wow, soft spun knit hooded, no less.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, neat. Wow, put it on. You can look like Mother Teresa.
All right.
Oh, look at her. She's going to grandmother's house. No, but we're right close up on your face there, Chief.
You know what? You're not going to have enough to take pictures of Bob and Sandy and Sean and all the little Indian rug rats that are running around over your grandmother, your grandfather, and it'll be done gone, so you'll never be able to take a picture of your mother and the other one that probably your grandfather mentioned last night.
I should heed that warning. Heed that warning from the pop, so we'll leave you with a nice shot of Stephanie. Hey, move your hair, will you? There, oh, she's wonderful, isn't she? The nice, lovely, wonderful, beautiful Stephanie Wichmann, my sister that you probably won't see until next Christmas. There we go. Bye-bye.
Hi, how's it going? We're back. I'm back here. It's, well, it's Christmas morning. I don't know exactly what time it is. It's about 12:30, but I'm about to go into Sandy's house, and we're about to meet some of the Bates Wheat clan, and we'll just see them and introduce you to the various members of our wonderful, diverse, and very colorful family. So, without further ado, here it is, the Wheat household.
Hey, you know what?
Merry Christmas!
All right, cool. You guys knew I was going to be videotaping, didn't you?
Hey, you know what they say about people that talk to themselves, don't you?
What are you saying?
What they say about people that talk to themselves?
Oh, yeah?
One of two things. One of them is they're crazy. The other ones, they got money in the bank. Which do you think you are?
Well, I don't have any money in the bank, so chow down on that chicken leg. That was, by the way, that was Grampy, the colorful one, you know.
The good-looking one.
Yeah, the good-looking one. All right, the good-looking one's behind the camera, big guy.
Yeah.
I'm right here.
There's Grammy. There's Grammy. What are you doing? What are you making?
Who are you talking to?
You.
I'm eating a piece of cheese.
You're eating a piece of cheese.
And
there is.
Right now.
There are the sisters.
The sisters.
The sisters.
The potato
sisters. Hey, the Potato Sisters, Aunt Sandy and the illustrious mom.
Hi.
What's shaking?
Hey, hey, Star Wars is on TV, Scott.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
You don't have to film, but it's already filmed. Merry Christmas, Potato.
Hi.
Tammy.
It's Tammy.
Hi, Tammy.
How's it going, babe?
Good. Here's tea in my Christmas
did
cup.
Did Santa bring everything you wanted?
It was very good to me.
Where's the Beamer?
Beamer is...
Beamer's on the floor somewhere.
All right, we'll have to go catch him. Hey, hi, Beamer. Hey, say
wave.
Hi.
Wave.
Say hi.
Say hi.
Say hello.
No?
How's it going? Hey, I hear a familiar theme in the hallway. Go. Yeah, all right. Isn't he cute? He's adorable.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. I want that spit to reach the lens.
One more time, ready?
Come on, guy. All right. Woo! Oh boy, he's got it going on.
He's got it going.
He's gonna be doing that all day, you realize.
He's got rimpy out of
it. Oh yeah?
Yeah, chocolate rimpy.
I'm gonna go venture in the other room. I'll be after. Oh, hold on. I hear a familiar voice. Hi, Katie.
Merry Christmas.
You look pretty.
Gotcha.
You look pretty.
I got a present in my hand.
You do?
Her sister looks just like her.
Oh yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Aren't they adorable? This is great.
Don't open that.
Tell them to show me.
No.
Where's the garbage?
You don't open that. That's gas, okay?
You are adorable, man. I told you he's going to be doing it all day.
Don't open that. That's for scat.
Look at the kitty. Look at there's the cat. Hi, Katie. I'm going to go walk in the other room. Hold on. What's going on?
I have no.
Hey, Scott.
How's it going?
No, aren't you cute?
Well, look. Oh, nice. Here's the moment of truth. The present from Sandy.
Down here. See.
Gotcha.
Don't keep your finger down on it. You don't have to keep your finger
Why?
Down. Why? You don't have to.
Oh, we don't?
No, take it off. Take your finger off it, but don't hit it again, because it'll shut it up.
Oh. I told you I'm not electronically inclined.
Oh, this is from the movie that's coming out.
Yeah.
The shirts aren't even out yet.
Oh, man! Look at that!
Phantasm.
The Phantasm.
The face off. Yep.
Cool.
That is awesome.
They're not even
Phantasm?
Out
yet.
They're not even out yet.
How the hell did you get this?
Hey, we have connections here.
Wicked.
They had a special show on QVC that I waited for and waited and I caught it. Yep. And I went to the phone and I called. And I
awesome.
Went to the phone again to get John one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They're sold out.
Wow.
They sold out that quick.
What?
My story quick. Yeah, I guess they am. The light on.
Put it in.
And they have those.
Cool.
Good job.
Don't play it, Bradley.
Wicked.
That's awesome.
No,
see that? You know who does his voice in the movie? Mark Hamill, who's on right now in Empire Strikes Back, if you're wondering.
Okay.
Well, cool. You fade out on that one.
I know. I'll call back.
What do I do?
Hit the button again. Hit the red button again.
Oh.
You don't like your camcorder, do you?
No, I love it. Fucking awesome. What is that? Football?
Super Tech Mobile and Nightmare Before Christmas on the board.
Nintendo, holy shit.
Sega, not Nintendo, Sega.
Whatever.
Get that thing off.
Where do I put this? Get that thing off. This is Sean, my cousin. He's on the phone. Who are you on the phone with?
Mark,
what's up, Mark? Okay,
like,
cool.
Like my own phone, Scott?
Ferrari?
Bright red.
Nice.
Dope. Yeah, my homie probably made out like a bandit like he does every Christmas. Going crazy. You get the Nightmare on Elm Street. Yeah, Nightmare Before
Elm
Christmas.
Soundtrack.
There it is, blaring.
Yeah.
Pretty cool. I'm going to try this fade out thing. Hold on. Never tried to fade out yet.
All right.
You'd be the first fade out victim.
Yes, fade out. Is it fading?
Huh.
We're trying to fade out.
Bye-bye. On the camera, big guy. Woo.
Ben Bates.
Yeah. Ben Bates. Beer drinker extraordinaire. Yep.
Masturbates.
Oh shit. He's the man. The myth, the legend.
The man that's a Giant fan, not a Chicago fan.
Well, I guess it's gonna be even more heartbreaking when they lose and they're so close to the Super Bowl.
Why closer than Chicago's gonna get?
Well, New England. You wait.
5-10 more years.
All right. Maybe.
When Purcell steals half the New York Giant players, then they'll get there, maybe.
Okay. Have another one. Hi, Kayla.
Yeah, I'll see you there.
What are you eating?
You.
the pineapple.
You eat it.
Put it down. I don't want that thing in my
face. I will. I'll have some.
Mommy, I don't want no more.
You don't want any pineapple?
Don't eat it.
Get in the broccoli and the rolls.
Hey, Louise. Grab this thing, will ya?
Hey, Tam. What you eating?
Applesauce.
Applesauce? You gonna share some with the Beamer? Hey, Beamer.
Beamer's guy is.
What's going on, big guy? What's your shirt say? Someone what?
Someone who loves me very much went to Lake George and got me the shirt.
Wave. Say hi.
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 I don't want milk.
Hi. That's your move?
Come on, Santa Claus will come back tonight, huh? And you know what's going to happen?
What?
You take all your presents. Why don't you
look at you.
Katie's pineapple.
Family patriarch
She's
doing his duty here.
Carrie.
Knock it off, Kayla. And you drip it all and everything. That's enough. No more. No more.
Hey, Carrie. What's going on, babe?
The drip of the pineapple.
Yay!
Look at him eat.
Like H-A-M.
You can pack stuff
H-A-M.
Away, can't you, man? Want another hot dog?
The one who loves broccoli, you put it right here. Should have let green out. Watch out for the milk. Pass some to Boppy. I'll get the roll.
I don't want any broccoli.
What's
in
my room?
Dinner is served. How's it going, Alfred?
That's
Clark.
Yeah, it's Clark. This is Clark W. Griswold.
Homer!
It's Homer Simpson, too.
I need a slab because of hand in the kids' play.
Tell you what, pass it right around the bed in there.
All right, well.
Hi, Graham.
Hi, Graham.
Watch it out.
I saw that. I saw that.
That's all right. I need a knife.
See how far that goes around.
Give me a knife. Will you?
Well.
Hi.
Well, our illustrious host has to eat something, so...
Don't whip them, but...
Fade out.
No, knives, Graham. Pointy ones.
Ma, watch. I'm going to fade out on you.
One's a pricker
I'm going to fade out.
Sandy?
He's drunk. He's out. One too many. Look at an armadillo. This is where Boba Fett chases after them. See, watch, him and Slave One just... Let's go eat something, dude.
Goddamn thing.
What's going on, big guy? We're experiencing technical difficulty. What's going on, Chief? How are you?
Good. How you doing?
Good. You have a good Christmas?
Oh, not bad.
You get lots of cool stuff? Yeah. We got a shy guy here. Look at him. Yeah, look at... There he is. No, don't tape me, please. No, especially don't tape me getting my ass kicked.
Zoom.
Oh, I don't want to zoom. this ends our broadcast day. Sweet Christmas tree. Looks like gifts underneath the tree. Let me get that in focus. Yes. Story of his life.
Hi, Scott. How are you?
Excellent. Oh, yeah. How's it going, big guy?
Shake my hand, fella.
Huh? All right, pal.
Do you know how
I'm back
you
up? Wow, holy cow. How's it going, Dave?
Did you get this for Christmas?
Yeah. No, I ripped it off. Of course I got it for Christmas. Whoa, holy.
There's no one in my tape. I'll tape.
And the
Come here, Benji.
The brass thing.
Come here.
The scarf. Were you over there?
Huh?
What?
Yes.
Yeah. Right.
How are they doing? All right?
I'm thinking. I'm thinking. Yes, they're gorgeous.
Give me a bark.
Okay.
Come on, I know you're working on it. Give me a bark.
Okay. Okay.
There you go.
No, I was up just, you know.
It's a high-pitched squealing noise.
Okay. Well, it said something about a mantle.
Give me a can of oil. He's squeaking. What Jen gets me. Here's Jen. Here's what Jen got me. Isn't that beautiful? Dynamite. See that word? The word personalized.
Put it away!
Isn't that awesome?
Isn't that great? I love that. It's just a dinosaur adventure. Your best friend, Jennifer. Merry Christmas, 1993. Isn't that great? I'll read it, but I'm not going to record it. Where are you? There you are. Isn't she great? Isn't she pretty? She's wonderful.
Stop.
All right, I'll knock it off. All right, this ends our broadcast day.
It's recording now. did you want me to talk about...
How's it going?
Okay, Scott.
Ta-da! Oh, zoom in on that M!
Yeah, zoom in!
How's it going, babe? Good to see you. Ow, I'm being pinched from behind. Hold on. This ends our broadcast day for the moment. All right. Hey, Gary. Wait, say hi. 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 That behind him is John. They're both my cousins. And, you know, this is the first time I've really had a chance to meet them. Isn't that weird?
It's not a real camera.
Yeah, it's a toy. And there you have Industrious John there, building a leaning tower of pizza. There, oh, can he go for... Can he go for seven? Goes for eight. He can't... He...
I didn't realize that was a toy.
Good job. Oh, and the rest of them. Gary, I'm going to start calling you the Godzilla brothers. You're just like building stuff up and knocking it down.
Oh, what's the body of the clown?
Oh, boy. This is great. Oh, this is some excellent theater here.
Who's the bad guy?
Oh, man.
You're encouraging.
You keep wrecking it. Yeah, I mean, you really shouldn't do that anymore. You should. All right,
okay.
This ends our broadcast day.
I've got a new Red Sox shirt, Boston Red Sox shirt here with all the Looney Tunes characters as Red Sox team members. That would be an interesting thing, I think, because you'd have the manager. You have the manager, Yosemite Sam, right here.
Ooh, I hate not winning.
And you got, and you got batting cleanup here, a Tasmanian devil. Wow! And then, let's see, what else we got here? We got, yeah, leading off in center field, Daffy Duck.
Flipper and succotash. Try and get that one by me, Buster.
And then on the mound, number 21.
Let's see if I can throw that cheese ball by him, Doc. Ain't I a stinker?
You need the greatest. This is the coolest t-shirt. Well, this ends our broadcast day. Just sit here and eat.
Watch me eat.
Here we have the Scott Wichmann special. Made with a hard roll, a little bit of mayo. See that right there? A little bit of lettuce.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got some ham here. A little bit of the hottest mustard on the planet. You know, makes your eyes water and you need four glasses of water after. And some turkey out there on the bottom. And then you just pick it up. Go like that.
She wants to zoom in. I want to zoom out on it. To my mouth?
I didn't even see it there. Well, when I went into Queen, and you looked at
the
you thought it was
Just back right out.
I went in and picked up the powder on Friday.
And a Pepsi. Nothing goes down better. Smoother.
And I just got
See you later.
What do you want? You want it?
Oh, wow.
Get up here. Put it together. Show me how to put it together. Put that. Put that right there.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, now put that on the peg. Put that peg in the hole. All right, yeah, there you go. There you go. Hold on. I think I got it. Technical proficiency with a camera. No, wait a minute. There we go. There we go. Ta-da! See? There you go.
He doesn't charge 10%.
Is that great or what? Go ahead, engineer man. Yep. Give it a good push. There we go.
I put off this individual heater because I realized he's sitting there, he's bubbling. I think he's going to be talking to people to eat it. And then I put it on another one, and we finally turned it on. Plus, the explosive deck also is on.
Beep, beep. Oh, you lost a sock.
You lost a sock? I just tickle your foot.
There's your sock.
There's your, oh, there it is, the sock.
A train sock.
It's a train sock, no less, see? There we go, getting his sock. Get that sock back, big guy.
You're going to put it on? Oh, you're going to put it on the train.
Yeah, right. You know what I used to do when I lived here? Was I used to have those fitted pajamas, right? And when I'd get up in the morning, I'd go from that. My room was down the hall. I'd come running in here. I had the fitted pajamas. This floor was all linoleum. I'd come whizzing across this floor, and then I'd hit right there, and I would stop, and usually I'd fall into the living room. Just fall right to the living room. Pretty cool, huh?
Oh, look out.
I'm glad it got there, oh, in time, geez. And I'm glad that you like it.
Come here, Gary. Come on, buddy.
Jeffrey like his Jurassic Park calendar. And
there we go. Oh, no, it's an oncoming train. I gotta back up.
Gary is the man.
Mark is not here right now. He's
what?
A good
his sock.
He got the
your sock fell off. Come on, buddy.
Cookies. And he's
Matt.
Mark's with his girlfriend right now.
Oh, no. Oh.
Pretty weird looking sight, but I'll let you know. This bathtub.
That bathtub is full of ashes because somebody burnt a candle, burnt tissue paper from a candle, and I dumped all the ashes in.
Now, yeah, this bathtub is where me and my dog first had a bath together. I was 8 years old, and Bandit jumped in the bathtub with me, and my dad got a picture of it. It was like amazing. Dog just jumped right in. I think I had to take like 4 baths afterward because he was so dirty, but anyway, this is where it happened. That's probably all the dirt that was left. And that was like 1980, so. Take a look at that. Here's my cousin John. And that's his little boy, Gary. And that's Gary's train, and that's Gary's
foot
with no sock on it. And this here, this room that we're in, used to be my room.
When?
Matter of fact, when we lived here, 1980, 81, whatever, 79 to 81.
No, this used to be my sister's room.
This is your sister's room? I think we've all lived in this house.
Yes, we have. Let's see. Originally, yes. The next room used to be my room. This used to be my sister's room.
Yeah.
And that was back in early 70s.
Early 70s. Jeez, I lived here early 80s.
Well, this is grandpa still owned the house.
Yeah.
So it was like early to 70. We lived here until 77. So.
Ta-da. This was my room, and my bed was this bed. Well, it wasn't this bed.
And I moved back here.
Yeah, that's right. You did. You moved right across the hall.
That's right.
This wall we're looking at, that's where my bed used to be, and I had a couple shelves over here, which if you can visualize, and that's the radiator that I don't know if it still has marks on it, but that's where I used to leave crayons, boy, and I used to catch major hell for that.
I think it's been painted.
Put crayons and all that other garbage on it. And this is all the assorted trophies and.
Here's a present owner right here.
The present owner. Back up, big guy.
Back up.
Of the big guy, Matt Wichmann, my cousin.
Of course, he does it the one time I don't clean the room.
Well, hey.
There's like stacks.
Oh, I know you're a tidy fella.
Just be lucky he doesn't come over to my mother's house and take a picture of my brother's room. Is it worse?
What are you doing with this wall?
I unwallpapered today because I didn't like it.
You didn't like what? Did you still have the space wallpaper?
It's still in the corner there a little bit.
And
it was kind of like half ripped down, so I finished.
Or extra gold. Yeah, see, there's a smidgen of the little wallpaper that he used to have on his. I kind of like it. See, I would leave it because it's got the tail end of them. No, I wouldn't because it's a Star Trek Enterprise. You get rid of that.
Okay, homies.
Homie grabbed the bull by the horns, and if you'd like to take a look right in here, you can still see my reflection.
You gonna buy a Cadillac convertible and put that on the foot of your car?
Yeah, that would be a great idea. Here, if you've got his GoBot collection, boy, oh boy. Well, I'm boring the hell out of whoever's watching this, but it doesn't matter because it's my video. So, we'll just end this section.
You like the Bigfoot? You show the Bigfoot?
No, where is the Bigfoot? Yeah.
Bigfoot.
Free HBO for 1 month with the Bigfoot purchase because, might I add, that my good boy Matt is a loyal Pizza Hut MVP.
Yeah.
You're right.
Did
Joy. And remember, if you're thirsty, this is a subliminal. Watch, subliminal advertising. Oh, man. Oh, whoa. Yeah, this is
it. Can't do it over there, Scott.
This is Jennifer. Hi. How's it going, babe? I haven't seen her in quite a while.
Quite a while.
Well, now I have you for all the world to see. For posterity's sake, you're right here in the middle of my frame. Say something for all the viewers that are bored at home. Hold on. Oh, there are two.
Say hi.
Hi. Hi, Johnny. What's up, buddy?
What are you
chowing on, man?
Cookie.
Yeah.
Who's this to? Everybody and anybody?
Everybody and anybody who, you know, stumbles into my room, picks up a cassette, and pops it in the VCR.
Say hi, Gary.
Gary, get up in the other arm, man. There, look at that. There we go. Hey, Gary, check it out. Look at that.
Wave,
Gary, John. Wave, because I just met you guys. Gary, hi. How's it going? That's a good thing to fade out on, as a matter of fact. Oh, gee, I'm giving away my secret. Hey, Gary! Man, he's getting huge. You know, every member of this family is getting huge. I think either that or...
Just because you're a midget.
Okay, here we go. Now, this part's going to have to be censored because blood will be drawn. No. Tough guy me.
You're huge, man. Don't scare me.
Hey, you can't hear me.
I what? Hey, that was good work.
You can't see me now.
What if I don't, like, want to?
You can see your butt.
You can see your butt.
You ugly butt.
Hey, Beavis, why are you so interested in my butt? So say something, Eric.
Yeah,
I don't have to say nothing. You're looking like a mall rat.
You can't see me.
The hat says what? Michigan? Yeah. But you chilling. Did you get good stuff for Christmas?
No.
Clothes? What's the matter with clothes? What are we playing here? Pac-Man?
I'm playing a skateboard game.
Oh, boy. Skateboard game.
That's me.
What's the matter with a normal board game?
I don't want to play a normal board game. You suck. This sucks too, but I don't play
the
whole board game.
Nice.
And they got a little boy here.
Oh, what is he doing? Kissing you? That's gross. You're witnessing a man who cannot escape fate. He's trapped. He is trapped. John, get out of there, man. Get out of there. Uh-huh. Yeah, he's thinking, uh-huh, yep, yep, right, right. I'm hungry. Okay, yeah. Let me at least take my jacket off. Let me at least take off my jacket. Okay, great. Yeah, sure. Okay, whatever. Listen, Miss Cohen, I really gotta go to the bathroom. Uh-huh. Sure, whatever. Uh-huh. Oh, boy. Hawaiian finger salute. I'm liking that. Okay, should we go metric or what? That's what he's thinking. Nothing. Nothing at all, and I don't even have a video camera. Well, this ends our broadcast day. It's on. You're on, baby.
I'm on. In there.
All right. They're in there. I'll go get them. Do you concur? Okay, great. I'm going for it. Dun, 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 dun. Look at, she's diligently reading.
You need a hobby.
No, this is it now.
Who got the camera?
Me.
From who?
My mother. Couldn't believe it.
Oh my god, she's gotta be nuts.
She is.
You must have been like an insane person all day today, weren't you?
Yeah, I'm one of those annoying people who lives down the street that comes in and videotapes like every moment.
We had at my house, Amy got puppy surprise. She opened, she goes, look, it was puppy surprise!
How many puppies were in it?
She got four. Jennifer was lucky. My sister bought her, and Lisa bought her one, too. She got hers, but Jennifer was ripped. She only got three puppies in her puppy surprise.
Oh, man.
It was kind of sad.
So did you have to, like, divvy up that extra puppy among the two of them?
No, it was just looked at very enviously by Jennifer. She just kind of, like, looked at
it. She stole it, I know, and she shoved it inside her puppy.
No, because it was... Amy's are pink and white, and Jennifer's are brown and white, so...
Okay.
Kind of segregated.
Did you see the puppy actually up close, and did he do any damage?
I didn't. How are you?
Can you describe the puppy?
I didn't eye them either way. Hi. Yeah. How was your Christmas?
Swish Pam.
I figured it out. Did he drive the red car?
I did.
Oh, the lights aren't on in the car.
Are they really?
No, they're not.
The light on, the little dome light inside.
Oh, inside is it on?
Yeah.
That's no big deal. Here, come wait. Hold on. Actually, I'll just give my keys to John and tell him to shut the lights off. Because at this moment, as we're talking right now,
yes?
John is stuck with the Cohen parents and he cannot move. He is paralyzed.
Have you tried?
No, I videotaped him.
Go away. We don't want any. House is full. Fine.
Oh, Tara. How's it going?
Do you know your lights
on? Yeah,
on
the inside.
How come I'm the only
one? I'm going to go give John keys.
Merry Christmas. Hey, Richard.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I'm reading a book.
I'll be with you guys in a second. We're going to play a game. You look
really
dapper,
exciting.
I tell you.
Oh, thank you.
We're going to fade out on. Let's see, who do we fade out on? Sean Flaherty.
Fade out on me, my gorgeous face.
Ta-da!
Yeah.
Okay, yep. Right.
Careful, it's a war zone.
Are you kidding me? No. You got to... No way.
Uh-oh. Sean's
going to... Mm-hmm. Sean's gonna save her. Sean's gonna save her.
Jen, sit down.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
I don't know. Yet. My bet. Actually, I know.
Hey, we have Feller.
Now you can zoom in it when you want.
Okay. Ready?
My hand. I am not touching this. Dina has full control of it, and it's going closer. Yep. Right up to her. Now she can back up for a wider shot of the whole entourage.
This
would
be the Christmas movie and Hulk.
Well, flashbacks right now then.
All right, ready? How far back
very
am I?
Disturbing.
You're far back enough where you want to stand up or something?
Just relax.
No, I'm just wondering how far back it will go.
This is about, I think, here, try it again. See how far back it will go. Yeah, it's keep going. Yeah, it's going back.
Going back. All
right, that's it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see how close
your heart's
going.
Yeah, go ahead.
It's so exciting. Oh,
yeah. Press it better.
What?
Point it directly at the thing.
I think that's a personal question.
I know.
You should ask her at a later date.
How are we doing?
Good.
Closer?
We are right up on your... Yeah.
Jen
just blocked the whole damn thing.
Oh, wait a minute. Still going?
Yeah. No, it stopped.
My flight is in.
I don't care.
A shot of Jen's unzipped fly. Ready?
Let's not.
I'm going to back it up again.
Okay, you can tell the party's dying when we're trying again. Yeah.
That's pretty neat.
Jen get naked.
Oh, this ends our...
Anything. Oh, can I have a copy of that?
You can't get John being on camera. Oh, ready? Come here. Come here.
I'm watching the game.
Come here.
Oh, am I here with you?
Jen's trying to be lovey-dovey, and it's, falling all over the place. All right, where's the zoom button again?
Did you press it? I did. I'm waiting for that little,
Indie glow.
Yeah, and I'm waiting for the...
On the top, and you push it forward.
I know.
Yeah.
Oh, that's like I do?
Yep.
Oh, hey. Total close-up
with John.
What? Three close-up!
John, just go
see out. Yeah.
Some people should not
be
allowed to watch Wind.
I saw Wind World, too. Third row. We almost had a
You're a mad woman, Dina.
Yeah, you know. Oh, we got the flowers in the way. It's there we go. There you go, Sarah. Go for it, John. Come on, keep it going. She hasn't noticed yet.
What?
How rich.
Hello,
that
Dina.
Was a sincere smile.
I have a better sincere smile.
Dad.
Dina, that's a great camera. I really like it. Turn it off.
This is the side of Mora, because she's not going to look. It's called obnoxious.
Give it a shot.
It's called obnoxious.
Yeah! Did you see that?
Whoa! Clear!
Yeah. Yeah. Scan on the back of her head. Seymour, you got some pretty nice looking hair. You must have used that brush. She used the big brush.
I want to see the white guy slim again.
That was her.
That's very rare.
Yeah. Alright, let's go shot the tree. Wait, we'll get a whole shot of the entire tree here. And we'll do it this way just to clean, confuse everybody.
Watching another move.
Hey, Scott, are you going to actually watch this later?
Do the Vanna thing. Do the Vanna thing.
Bitch, my roommate.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
We'll confuse you when you're watching this later. Look at the whole tree.
What the hell are you doing?
She's
wasting
your battery.
That's
alright. I like the nose cozy, yes.
Oh, that's offensive.
Where'd Jen go? Or is she answering the phone again?
Probably.
Okay, now, if you want to... You fade, you just hold it down?
Yeah.
Your nose on it.
And then you have to...
It was an interesting first day using the camera. We met a lot of people, chilled out, hung out, saw Chris, my niece Ashley, Stephanie. We saw Kayla, Katie, Grampy, Grammy, Tammy, Carrie, Sandy, Bob, Sean, my mom. Then we went to Cohen Residence. We saw Jen and her parents, and maybe we might have got a fleeting glimpse of Patrice. And then we went to the Wichmann's house, and we saw Charlie and Margaret, and Aunt Jan, Eric, Jennifer, John, Matthew. We met Gary and John, the two little kids. We also saw Grandpa Ed and Lydia, and we saw Lee, and we saw all these different people. And then we went back to Jennifer's house, and we saw John B. and Sarah and Sean Flaherty, and Jennifer again and her parents. And this time we got to see Maura and Richie, and then we caught a glimpse of Dina, the former girlfriend, love interest, whatever. So I had a good day with this camera today, and learned how to use it pretty well. Took it to some interesting places. Stuck it on the dashboard of the car. Yeah, what the hell, it's on tape. But I had a lot of fun today, and it's now 3:25 on the 26th. So it's the day after Christmas, and the big day after Christmas letdown is probably going to hit pretty soon, but it doesn't matter because I'm probably going to be sleeping through it. But without further ado, never know what could be on this tape after this part, but for this particular section, the Christmas section, good night.
We have our coffee. See, there's a little bit of sugar in there. It's kind of good. And here we have our microwave with nothing. Wait, where the hell is it? There it is, our tasty bit of water. Yeah, okay, yeah, our water is, ah, damn, that's hot. Okay, so what you do is, you go to your drawer, you take out any ordinary spoon, okay, take it, put it next to it, take your water, doing this left-handed, don't try this at home, kids, yeah, and pour it in, and then switch hands, ta-da. Now, for those of you who can't hack the taste of coffee with no milk, well, bam, refrigerator. Go to get your average milk. Let's see what the expiration date is. 24. Some of the bacteria is here. Let's smell that. Let's smell this. Too bad this isn't like aromatic TV. See anything in there? Hold on. Whoa, boy! Let's get rid of that. December 24th. Jesus. Santa came and so did the bacteria. Wow. That one's history. Get that one out of there. Yeah, boy. Ah! Ah! Merry Christmas. Yeah. All right, now, don't want to put that in our coffee, otherwise, well, you'd be dead. So, now, we go to the refrigerator and go and get some milk that isn't, like, dead. Okay, the 29th. A little bit better date, this being the 26th. We got 3 days until the bacteria gets here. Let me show you how to get milk off here. Oh! Damn! Hold on. We're experiencing some technical difficulties with the milk. And we're gonna see if we can pour this while actually holding a camera. Does it look like a Coffee Mate commercial? Hey, would you like some coffee, mate? Okay. Pride can hurt you too. How's that look? Good? Yeah, that's pretty good. And then you take and you put the cap back on, or you can do it Grammy style. Grammy does this. This is what she does. There you go. That's it. So you just take it off. So it looks like it's on. And you go to the refrigerator. What do we got in this refrigerator anyway? Any like cool stuff? Nah, nothing really good. Okay, this will probably go pretty good in the damn coffee. You know you should eat lettuce! Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Eggs, okay. We'll be right back.
Hold on. To maybe make breakfast a little bit more fun. Okay, got my McDonald's hat. Gonna show you how to make an egg McMuffin. You just stare right there. The first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure, hold on, I'm gonna leave the screen for a moment. Make sure you... Pans are good, okay? Now you take your pan, you take your no-stick Pam, all right? Pam and the pan, they go together. See this? Nice little spray right there. Then, take your oven here, your burner, you set it to medium-high. You put the pan with the Pam on the burner. And I'll show you the next step in a moment. We're back right here. Basically, the next step after we've put the no-stick Pam in the pan is we take our egg, okay? Our basic round, oval, whatever the hell shape this thing is. Uniform white substance, this little egg thing here, okay? Now, we're going to have to crack it in this pan here. And to do that, I'm going to use a line that Jack Tripper, remember Jack Tripper from Grease Company, said, in order to teach someone how to cook, because there's an art to breaking an egg. Basically, first you have to make friends with your egg, right? Hi, how's it going? Good. Okay, great. Make friends with your egg, now break your friend. And there he is, he's history. Whoa, boy. Take your shell, run to the garbage. And now, we're gonna take... Oh, well, it's not done yet. I'm gonna say, take our British muffin out of the... It doesn't have to be English, it'd be British. You could take your muffin out of the microwave. And while this guy's cooking here, I'm gonna show you some of the ingredients, some of the little things we got going with it. We have our friendly neighborhood spatula, right? Spatula. Basically, when I worked at McDonald's, I was a grill sergeant. Forget it! And we have some Hickory Farms Tangy Bacon Cheese Spread that's gonna go on that muffin when it's done. Just a minute, I can't like it. Ooh! We have a winner! So now we're gonna take this thing here. We're gonna hack it in half. Okay? I don't think any McMuffin ever in the history of the world has taken this long. But now we take our toaster, bam! Toast it. In just a minute, I gotta get a plate. We got our egg here, he's doing pretty good. Looking just great. Gotta flip him. We have to turn it up to a little bit higher. I almost said speed. Higher temperature. We'll
sip of our coffee, our java that we just made. And you can do this at home. You can, make some nice instant coffee and make a nice egg McMuffin and finish the coffee before the McMuffin's done so you have nothing to drink when you're eating. And then if you have two cups, you're like stuck to the ceiling because you had too much caffeine. My mother always used to do that with me. She'd be like, she'd have like 6,000 sugar cereals, right? In the morning, she'd say, have another bowl, have another bowl, have another bowl. And then by noon, I was like gone, sugar high. And I'd come down crashing. I don't know where I get all this energy, Margaret. Not from my side of the family. Little entertainment while the thing's cooking. Let's check our English muffin. No, he's not done yet. So we'll have another sip of coffee. And while we're, while we're waiting here, I want to tell you that this show is brought to you by Dick's Drapes, because nothing hangs like Dick's. Did I say that? I said that. Well, it's, can't take it back now, Bob. Well, what's going to go on this thing is we're going to put some of Price Chopper's best. What the hell kind of ham is this? Old world cooked ham. Just cooked in the old world. Oh. Old pig. And there they are, our friends, the McMuffin brothers. How's it going, guys?
Good, great.
Okay, so now what we do is, what are we gonna? I know I'm right in your face, huh? Like that, see that? Egg McMuffin. Ow, steaming hot. Anyway, you take your McMuffin here. You take this nice cheese spread, as you can maybe see. There you go. And you just spread that puppy on there. See? Watch this. See, and then you do this here.
Oh, my hand!
No. And what do we got here? Oh, yeah, our egg is dying. So now we take our egg, place them atop the World Trade Center, and throw them off. Damn it. Backfires. And, we pretty much got a good thing going here. You can do this at home. Go probably quicker than I can. And now, see the pan? I've used it. It's kind of crappy looking now. It's steaming. And listen to this cool sound. Hold on. Here we go. Hold on. Just a second. This is the best part of cooking an egg. And it's steaming hot. Yes! Watch this. Cool. Oh, it didn't do it. It didn't do it. A backfire, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry. I'll refund your money. And, maybe it'll happen when you cook it at home. But we'll be right back. The world cooked ham, our coffee. Okay? And you're set for a great breakfast here. Take a little piece of old world cooked ham. Come on, get out of there. Oink. And you just place it right there. And zoom in on this puppy. Here we go. Get tight on that. There we go. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. It's done. And we get our cup of java. Ah! There you go. Only $2.99 at your participating McDonald's.
Maybe flip like checking it hot. Of course, I come across with the pill for sure. I don't.
give me the microphone before I bust my pants. I'm at author of anguish, my language polluted. Onyx is heavyweight, it's still undisputed. If it's the words I have, I'll have to walk a mile in my shoes. I've been so many dudes, I'm abused and abused, and I'm so confused. Now, excuse me, for example, I'm an inspiration of a whole generation. And unless you got 10 sticky fingers, it's an imitation, a figment of your imagination. But wait, it gets worse. I'm not going down, so I'm dying of thirst. Coming through a wood scale, foolproof plan. B-boys make some noise and just kill.
Here, kitty, kitty. More.
Too flamboyant. No. Exhausted all my options. This doesn't work. Nothing will. Let's try this one. Ah. I like it. It works. That's the one. That's the one we'll pick.
All right.
Yeah, it's 9:25 a.m.
We got 5 minutes to get there.
And so I'm just going to make this short, but this is sort of a little preface as to what's on this tape. Hey, if I get lucky, you might have a little surgery on tape here. I'll see what I can do with my Hillcrest inside, you know.
We'll see you on the other side. Come on.
We'll see you later.
Our Hillcrest Hospital, this is the place. The place where... Yeah, where my tonsils are going to rest forever. Great, isn't it? Yeah. We'll take you inside in just a moment. Nice place. Nice place. And guess who that is? It's Dad. He decided to stand in for me and get his tonsils taken out instead.
Hi, Scott.
Very well put. What? Hi, Mom. How's it going?
You ought to go into the operating room with that thing there and watch them take them out?
Sure, why not?
Okay, I'll see if I can do that.
This is the before shot. And then, well, probably I'll be pretty annoyed later on. I'll be probably too annoyed later on to have an after shot, but hey, what the hell.
Okay,
this is basically just killing time before the damn thing happens.
Or I will be in massive pain. Yeah, I got a camcorder.
My deepest sympathy.
Yeah, there we go. Wonderful. Great. The accommodations are perfect. Say hi. How's it going? This is for posterity, you know, for whenever I'm just saying, gee, I really want to relive those wonderful moments of tonsillectomyhood. What?
When your auntie be accepting your Tony, I don't
know. Okay, hey, great.
Watch TV someday that, and say, guy, I remember
that guy. That guy photographed my button.
That's my wonderful Reeboks. Aren't they nice? I won't be able to use them for another couple days. Wow. Over and out.
Seconds ago.
Oh, I didn't want to tape it 5 seconds ago. This was the most horrendous part of the whole experience. I just got shot in the arm, right? I almost that's why I'm like half upside down. I almost passed out. I had to stick my feet up here, right? And, well, of course, I made a deposit right there. You know, it's the worst part of the whole damn experience. But it's over. I mean, I got this tube sticking in my arm now, and I'm being fully hydrated. I said if they wanted to hydrate me, why don't they just throw a bucket of cold water on me? But anyway, instead of having to jam something in my arm. But anyway, here I am, and, you know, maybe if we're lucky, we'll get to go into the operating room. I got connections.
But this is the aunt. Yeah. This is my aunt in all of her splendor.
I can't believe he's doing that.
I can't either.
What can't you believe?
Did you take a picture of Jan?
Yeah.
He should have taken one of me putting in that beautiful ID that he gets right
God.
Now.
Oh,
He was busy barfing in the basin.
I was busy barfing in the basin. Yeah, that's what happened. Yeah, that's what happened, everybody at home. Thanks a lot.
Hold on, let me think about this for a minute.
Sam, did he read his card?
Yeah, that was a great little card. Can I have the card? Put it in the camera. Congratulations, happy Hanukkah, good luck, get well soon. Was my deepest sympathies. What was the other one? The best wishes, yeah. She flips it in there, she said she didn't know what occasion it would be, so she just had made it for them all. Certificate entitles a fair to one, all the free jello he can stand. Love on Sandy, and that's her ice cream too, yeah. Isn't she wonderful? Wristband, I don't know if you can read it.
Sure.
Okay. Which man low did you? Ah, a phone call. Wait a second. Let's find out who this is. Hello? It's not from Illinois. Ha, huh? That's what Grammy says. It's not from Illinois. Pretty good, Graham. How are you? You didn't know I was going in early? Oh, really? No, I went in at 9:30. Say hi to all the viewers at home. Yeah, right. Yeah, I can't eat anything. Stinks.
I mean, I really do like comedy at night. And
yeah. Yeah, I know. I'll be fine. No, I'm not nervous. They stuck the needle in me and I didn't take it too well. But that's me. Say what? I hate needles. It's the worst part. So. I will. I will. I got no choice but to hang in there.
Watch it because now.
Dad, you're recording. You're still recording. You're recording the floor now.
I'm not recording anything.
Yeah, you are. The light's on.
Is it on now?
Yeah, you're recording. It says you gotta hit the red button.
Yeah. Does this thing focus by itself,
Scott? I feel like a Flintstone. Look, I got big old bald feet. All right, cool.
Bald feet.
Stick here. Sorry about that.
Ooh, that's okay. Sam is waiting for his operation. I know he's getting nervous because he's seeing me go, but good luck, buddy. Have a fun.
Come back or when you wake up.
Yeah, yeah, we'll see. We'll see you later on. We probably won't both be able to talk. We'll just be like this.
Don't sneeze.
Oh, going.
You gotta DC that Boston Red Sox hat.
Okay, go ahead.
If it was Yankees, we'd keep it.
Oh, boy. Can't believe you live in Massachusetts. We'll see you later. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Gary. Thanks a lot, man. And here we are. Dun, dun, dun,
we'll give
dun,
you the
dun,
grand
dun,
tour.
Dun,
can I get that old lady right there?
Yeah. Oh, hey.
Watch, might catch her fall on the...
Let's see, we'll probably have to stay behind her.
Watch her trip, right?
Knock her over.
Did I say that? I said that on camera. What a vicious bastard. Look out. It's the surgery. It's the late night surgery cam.
Hey, you know what? You know what?
If you
see some of the nurses down there, you might want to put that on pause.
Oh, boy. I got that admission.
There, look at my feet.
Ooh.
A couple of them you need a wide-angle lens.
How are you, sir? This is you're on candid camera. This is the late night surgery cam.
Yeah,
you had your tonsils out, didn't you?
Yeah, well actually no, I haven't yet, otherwise I wouldn't be talking.
Going up, we wanna go down.
Oh, you're going up?
That's going up, I think. Yep, see?
Okay. There's the critical care unit that I was in a couple weeks ago. Yeah, and they're a rowdy bunch in there. I had mononucleosis and my throat almost closed.
Oh,
yeah.
That's infection, huh?
Brought him in here.
Very quiet.
Wow,
almost. But what the hell?
Yeah, throat almost slowed up.
And while we're waiting,
they said they gotta go.
See if this really works, you'll be able to see my hand.
Oh yeah, see? There. That's beautiful.
This is the volunteer. Say hi.
There's the volunteer.
Hi.
Hi. How are you? There we go. Here's our elevator. This is what the elevator looks like.
Yeah. This is one of the nicest elevators.
Technological terror you've created
way.
Here. It's like I'm in
Thank
the
you.
Death Star.
See, get me getting G. See, it's going to the garage. We actually have a garage. Put him up on the lift and get
where
him
we're
going.
Yeah, that's where we're going to be.
You got a wide-angle lens on that?
No, I wish
Some
I did.
Some of the nurses you're going to need that for.
Ooh, boy. He's talking mad smack.
Okay.
See, there we say
operating
room.
Are you going to be okay?
Yeah, I'm just going to leave the, you know, I'll
take it back, or we'll see. Okay. We'll see. Yeah. We'll run it up to you. We'll keep performing recovery.
Great.
Maybe you can.
All right, we'll see you in a bit, Scott.
Okay, Dad. Bye. Bye, Mom.
Give me a kiss.
All right. Oh, hold on. Here's the kiss.
Lunch here. Bye.
Here, get that.
Eating lunch. Nice stuff. I won't be able to eat anything solid, so hope you like it. How are you? Nice to see
you're on candid camera.
That's right. Authorized personnel, no street clothes, blah, blah, blah. What is this, the maternity ward?
Yeah, maternity. See, watch, see what I'm set up.
Yeah,
up on
her. I hear what you're saying. Yeah. Yeah, he couldn't be more right. Here
yeah,
is
you
a,
got a hat.
You show the nice hat to all the folks at home.
Oh, okay.
Okay, that goes off here.
Yeah. That goes right in my head.
Okay.
He just went down to surgery. He'll be back in 2 hours. This is Lorraine after she gets her done. Say hi, Lorraine. This is Lorraine after she gets her done, though.
Lorraine?
Uh-uh. Nighty-night, Lorraine.
There you go. Make sure you get me. I'll get back. Wave. He survived Hillcrest, Bob.
Excuse us for a moment.
Baby, I don't want to go on camera this time.
Go get him.
Thank you.
Hi, Scotty. Hi, Grammy.
Hi.
Grammy's going home. Happy New Year. Stop crying, Scott.
Happy New Year.
Sing us a song.
Take the tree down.
Oh, the tree? Where's the tree? There's a sad looking tree. Merry Christmas. Okay, Scotty, I'm taking Grammy home.
He's getting Gloria real well.
Oh, come on.
Oh, look at her. She's embarrassed.
It's going to be published in those magazines.
Oh, come on. He's just had it since he's got the thing.
God bless you.
He wanted to bring it to the operating room.
He did.
He took it away from
him. He did.
Her. Yeah, I couldn't get it past the tiller of the nurse.
I would have gladly mounted it in the ceiling.
That would have been awesome. Oh, well.
Okay. Time for Scott to have his examination.
They're gone. They're history. Okay. Wait, are you zooming in real close?
Yeah, real close. Open up.
That looks like a nice toy, huh?
All right.
Isn't that great? He's having more fun than mine. We should have gotten him one.
I know. Well, he's already got his
picture. Okay. Say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Bye-bye. End of story. Nice book, baby. She's got it going on. I'm right up on her, too.
I know, that's cool.
See, Dan is tattoo shopping. He's browsing. He wants to get the huge one of Thomas Tip O'Neill that's going to take up his entire back. You know, Tip O'Neill making flipping hamburgers in the nude. The big picture.
Actually, we just read it for the titties. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, that's right. Dan looks and says, well, you got a titty hanging out. With Danny and Angel, nice picture. Yeah, see, we went through a tour of my room on the first video thing that I ever took when I first got the camera. And so now we have the tour of Dan's room.
The tour.
The 180 hats that he's got. Just like the hats that undoubtedly, if you've been playing at home, I got a shitload of them too. See, there's Dan's many conquests up there. I guess if you are what you have in your room, this means Dan's pretty horny.
Can't beat that.
Can't beat that with a bat.
I like women when they get the little rose someplace. A small one.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Woo!
Can't beat that shit.
The R2-D2 clock. and the lamp. You can't beat that. There's a couple of pictures on here. Hold on. What a picture of two eligible bachelors at this point.
Look at that tie.
Jeez, look at that tie. Look how short it is on Dan.
That was the worst.
I think we look kind of shitty.
Yeah, I think that's...
God.
So
and I think the most pathetic aspect of it is that we thought we were so cool.
That was the most pathetic aspect of it.
Look at that. Jesus, what a moron. What a double moron. Of course. And see the height on me? I think it just stopped at that point, and Dan just skied. Well, brilliant. Show it to your folks at home. Now everyone has a copy. Brilliant photo. There we have it. That's Trials of Life right in Dan's room.
It's
here.
Just being attacked. Don't swing your tail at me. Swing on a piece of
that. That's Otto. Say hi. Wave to the folks at home, Otto. Now see, look, Otto's getting, he's getting camera shy. He's like, I want to make a break for it.
Bean massacre.
Otto, you're just chilling. See, look at him. He wants to make a break for it. Oh, look out. He's loose.
The vicious beastie.
Yeah, I guess the damn thing in focus.
Use that focus?
Yeah, I use that sometimes.
You never use the other one?
No.
It's like automatically don't focus.
Oh, yeah? Where is it?
It should just do it automatic.
Oh, yeah, it does.
Give it a couple seconds.
Let's see, because right now this the Loch Ness Monster here is just a blob. Damn it.
Can't get it?
Mm-mm.
Should it go by itself?
Hold on. Otto, you're just hanging out, aren't you? Oh, they're feeding him again. Dan, if you feed him too much, he's not going to want to eat none. Look at him.
The bean eater.
The bean eating freak. Hmm. He's saying, yeah, well, you know, just hanging out here on the ledge. See, look, Otto, don't do it. Well, that's the food chain demonstrated right in Dan's home.
Bean eater.
Looks like, you know what he looks like? Get a Star Wars figure and put it on his back like a, he looks like the patrol Dewback. Big monster.
Yeah, well.
Come on, eat another one.
Be a man.
You fool.
I'm gonna be a punk.
Yeah, he's in the cage. Well, that was Otto, the amazing
iguana.
Freak.
Amazing nutcase.
Tucked up against the wall, like he's in a lineup, or like he's trying to escape. We have Tiny, a freaking weirdo.
Freak.
He's just like chilling. See, Tiny thinks that he's Spider-Man. And he's been hanging out there since 11 o'clock this morning. I swear.
They're gonna get a cool Joker tattoo.
Oh, yeah? Well, that's him. He's nowhere near as interesting as Otto, but you realize that from a distance you can't spot him. See? Where the hell is Tiny? I don't know. Is he in the cage? No, he's loose. No, he isn't. There he is, right there. Ta-da! Otto. I wonder, you should throw Otto in there with him.
Like,
yeah, that's what I'm saying, guys. Then we could market it as the Trials of Life video in the Walker household. Yeah, well, see you later.
Here tonight, Lee Marvin, Ryan Johnson, Katie Harding, and Susie Amling, and of course also to Larry Bud Melman and Bridget.
Hey!
Out there on the street trying to get people to defect. Tomorrow, folks, it's going to be...
Get away from me. There's the happy couple. Yay!
And
Lying Soviet scum.
Thank you so much.
Hey, you know what you're on? Dan? Videos.
Super high.
Come on, look over here, angelic one.
No, I don't want to.
You look even more, you look stupid when you're not, when you're resisting. There you go. Oh. Your dog looks stupid on the video. It's David Letterman! Oh, the guy with the dustbuster, all right.
The downstairs.
This is a really beautiful downstairs. We've got a nice wallpaper here. I really love this feature. And the phenomenal kitchen area where we see the Walker family preparing their fabulous, wonderful repast. And here we have the wall of fame, as it were. The picture of little Danny Walker. There he is. Shit. There he is. Oh. And there's a man.
A close-up of Angel's ass. There it is. It is very nice. I like it muchly.
What?
Making on.
Oh, I'll just have one, and I'll toast myself some bread.
Yo! I got a game.
Where's the bread?
It's Scott's butt. Dude, nice sweat.
Thanks. That's all I own. I am Adidas, man.
Adidas.
I am Nike, man. I am the bread, man.
Nice smile. What do we have?
Nothing.
Butter in a pan.
And a big, fantastic menu. And a little bit of gin. And some butter. And then the steak goes into the medium high pan. And on the other end, we have Scott preparing bread in the toast oven. He presses the button with his dexterity and the minimum rate. And then he uses the little twisty tie thing. And he's really cool. And he likes niggas with guns and things with titties. And I love to make a movie.
You have dandruff. I can see it.
You do too. Yeah, it has dandruff. I seen it when I walked in the door.
Can I grope you in the kitchen?
No, you can't.
Can he grope you anywhere else?
No, you can't.
Right.
You liked it a half hour ago.
got that, America?
I'm sending this tape in.
To America's funniest fucking people.
Under.
See, we have these flank steaks here are right off the movie set of Alive.
This is that ugly guy's ass.
This is Columbia's ass flank steak. Did you notice? The right cheek is tastier than the left, usually, and we'll hand the spatula to the one that is the most proficient, and you'll notice that I have 39 lines at this point in the game. And the crowd is going crazy. Wow, look at that. See, if you'll notice the ectoplasmic residue.
Oh, you do? Cheese dick.
See, that shows the tremendous foresight of Angel. Getting a plate for me. Thank you. That's the one?
Yes, there's 2 hours.
That's good. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Give me a thumb.
There are the two little runts.
playing poker or whatever. You notice they're all tough guy sunglasses and the tough guy hats. There's the Celtics t-shirt rolled up. The real tough Andy Cap hat. Yeah, we really thought we were cool. This imbecile. I don't know, but he sure is weird. Nice shirt, isn't it? There's Danny, me, and my cousin Sean. Again, thinking we're cool with tough denim jackets and our Chuck Taylor sneakers. Notice my eyes are shut. Jesus Christ. Bugs at Danny's birthday party. I forget how old he was, but let's see if I can name these people. Richard Motzik works for UPS. Dan Wido, the geek, one of the Marine Corps. Dan Walker, the main man. Ken, I don't know what happened to him. Bill Williams, I dated his sister for a while. And there's yours truly. Notice the sharp hairdo. That handsome devil. I don't know, but he sure looks really neat. That gritty outdoorsman with his Kermit the Frog boots on. You'll notice there, I don't know if you can see it, but it actually does say Kermit the Frog on the side. What a thug. Walker, the Halloween bum, dressed as a hobo. I forget what year that was. I think I was like a ghost or something that year. Well, we were really cool. It's Rich Motzik, Dan Walker, and Scott O. With the weird looking... What am I shouting at? I don't know. I look like I just got out of a mental institution. The hell I don't know what my hair was. Yucko. Here's the first date. The first real big dance we ever went to. It's like 8th or 9th grade or something like that. It's one of the homecoming dances. And from the left, we have Scott O and his beloved, illustrious, and, well, tall date, Ann Williams. Then Tammy Crittles, who John Thomas is going to marry in about a year. And Dan O. Boy, they sure do look neat. Ann and his date. She sure was a looker back then. I wonder what she looks like now. He snagged himself a fine homecoming wench and some devils. Notice the pink tie I'm wearing. I look like a goober. But I thought I was so neat. And there's Big Dan, getting ever so much bigger than we saw him in the last picture compared to me. There we are, circa 2011. I was a junior in high school. We were juniors in high school. Going to another homecoming dance with the illustrious Hardy. Her in her pink dress. Oh, boy. We know, sir, I look like Mike Myers from Wayne's World. And there's Danny and his date, Brenda. Brenda Miner. We just went to her house the other night. So there we were. Danny had just gotten his driver's license, and we were off to the races. With our woman in tow. We had a pretty good time at that dance. It was it was all right. At the bonfire, some kid almost beat me up because he thought he was in love with Missy, and I was with her. Jason Edwards, he was a geek. Pictures of Thunder Dan and the Skywalking Man. Thunder Dan the Skywalking Man and Scott O. Lisa Bauer. Should have been a model, but I don't know what she's doing. She's going to Syracuse University now. I had the crush on her of a lifetime, and I guess you folks at home can see why. She looks like I cut her out of a catalog and put her in this book, but you will see that she's indeed a real living, breathing person. So there's her, there's Nikki, there's Kim, there's Faith. What the hell was her name? I don't remember. Dan's cousin. Haha, Julie. Some other people. Joe Bushta. Brett Van Fleet, the shitter. That guy took a dump in his pants one time. He crapped his pants, for real. John Thomas is going to marry Dan's old homecoming date. He's a pretty neat guy. There's John Mosick, the one-legged wonder. Ooh, and we have yet two pictures. There's the Wichmann twins. Those guys are really talkative, and when one of them gets one ear and the other one gets the other one, boy, look out. Swish pan!
What are you doing?
I don't know, gardening, I thought. I'm going through this friggin' photo album. Let's see what else I got here. Oh, Connie, Heather. Chad. When he blows his temper, he's weird. He played the entire ninth inning of a game at shortstop with a spider on his shirt. Kristen Freeman went to school with me. There's the shitter again. There's Holbert. Dickbag. Jen Ferguson. Dan had a chance, but he blew it. Moron. Dano's cousin. His prom pictures. He went with the coolest girl in the school. She was really awesome. Treasurer at graduation. Had to make a speech. I don't know. Probably, you know, said how much was in the collection box. I don't know. I wasn't there, and it was kind of tough to not be there. But I was real busy, and he didn't get to come to mine either, so. Missed a lot of each other's lives. And there's Angel. Danny's one and only. She's a sweet doll. Oh, really?
Sure, man, you could go see that tomorrow night, Amy. Suck. I swear we're hitting everything before. Alright. No more Mrs. Nice Guy. Back. backboard maintenance complete. I can't even hit the backboard.
Oh, you can.
Yeah! Oh. You would have to hit one.
Yeah, the crowd gun!
Oh. Behind the back! Oh. What a block.
What a block.
There's no other
from the kitchen.
Oh,
it's a leader.
Oh. All right. Oh boy. Hold on. Oh shit! Fix your net. If I win, I get to snip them down. In the lane, skies! Yes!
If I can't give it to him, why should he give it to
somebody? I think I can get him on the delay of game call. My nose, Dick. Number, Dad. Clean.
No more gold.
God. No more mustache either. I even had to use the scissors. You know it's getting thick when you have to use the scissors. This razor's just about shot. I only cut myself once.
Right there.
Not too bad.
Snowman! Come on! Wow!
Adam!
Yeah.
Hey, Snow Boy, what's going on?
What are you going to tell Pop?
Called him up and he's... If you want to come over and you
can... Yes! What were you going to tell him?
Get out of the house, I think he's bored.
You're going to tell him something? Go what? Go 49ers! Go tell him.
No, they
come here and tell me.
Go 49ers.
Yeah, that's good though.
Tell him.
Great.
Tell hey. Scott.
Yeah, here, tell me what...
What are you going to say?
Come here, look, Phil, Dad.
You want to look through this?
Yeah.
Okay, just a second. Here. Here, who do you see? Come here. No, look over here. Other eye. Who do you see?
Papa. Daddy.
Is that who you see?
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at him. Nice hat. Who's on your hat?
Oh, you found a trick.
Who's on your hat? 49ers? Say, go 49ers.
Go 49ers.
Hey, Adam.
Yeah.
What did you do today? Did you play?
Yeah.
What did you play with?
Toys.
Where's Amanda?
Preschool.
At preschool?
Yeah.
Did you find your other mitten?
Yeah.
All right. Way to go, Chief. Can I see it? Here, hold it up. There's your other mitten.
Mm-hmm.
Wave. Say hi.
You gotta take your coat off?
Yeah, take your coat and stuff off.
Goodbye.
He said he's gonna be a telephone operator.
He said, what's up?
Good.
Where did I get it? His brother broke her in half. What the hell?
Yeah.
He says, he did order. He said, he ordered 4 or 5. He said, well, I got a hell of a beer, but that was guaranteed when I went off the door. He said, I'll tell you what
I'll
do. He said, I'll give you this one for five. It's like,
oh, good.
I think he probably was about $35.
Amazing Spider-Man.
Thank you.
She's got me. He's got the world. He's got me. He always, he's got me. He's got his friend. She's crafting. She's just my friend. She's crafting. He's got the world. She's crafting, man. She's always there. He's crafting. She's got a great. She's crafting. She's just my type. She's crafting.
Here's the 3-2 pitch from Ad-Rock, and it is swung on and missed strike three as Mike D takes a look. He's whacked. He's going to get the girls, and here comes Ad-Rock. Here comes the honey.
Yeah.
Look at him, get her with the honey. How will she wash that out, Dan? With your tongue. You want your tongue in her hair? In her hair? Nice. It's like Missy's hair. Just like she's going to a Bon Jovi concert. We could use that. What are you doing? Dumping it out. I would never in the history of my life waste that much beer. But look at, see? Never waste that much beer by dumping it on a chick. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, hey, you maybe. Wow.
Of injustices was just pummeled upon the Beastie Boys.
No, I liked it.
They were arrested for those activities. Don't see anything going around like that here.
I'm having you on the team.
What are they doing?
So Scott Wichmann, America's number one public enemy, was arrested along with his cronies, Richard Mossick and Daniel Walker.
Hey.
You're working too hard.
No, I gotta stop.
Whoa!
The butt master.
You better work, girl. Jesus Christ.
You got the queer bastard in the back.
Yeah, see, the token gay guy is in the background there.
What is his name?
Richie.
His name is Richie. That's right, the Twinkie. Hello, Twinkie Bell back there. Oh, man.
The rocket queer.
Keep that stomach in tight. Okay, slow it down.
This woman moron.
Huh? What'd you say?
It's the rocket queer Richie and the lovely maid moron.
Excellent.
Just don't try to steal her feminine napkin off from her. While she's eating at friendly, she gets perturbed.
She's a bitch.
She's ugly, too.
She's got more gums than damn Wrigley's.
Does Richie actually, like, sleep with her? Bring it down,
stretch it. I wonder what would that be like. Yeah! This is the cool-down portion of the cycle.
It's buttocks to the ceiling.
It sure as hell is.
Good. Now what we're going to do is slowly alternate. And it's five. Good, good.
She.
Six, let's add.
And then after this is over, I take them all out to dinner.
Keep on going. Five.
Except for the queer in the background. Hi, hi there, ma'am. What's your name? Oh, damn it. Oh, hi there. How are you? She's the best one in her row, I think.
Take your time out slowly. Add down again. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hello? Pippi Longstocking, she got bigger.
Hang on, that's good.
What the hell is this shit? You're driving him crazy, Dan. He likes to put on a dress and be free! Holy Jesus. Looks like Elvis Costello on steroid high. Yeah. God damn. I wouldn't want to play on their team, if you know what I'm saying.
What?
In the song's called Laid.
I'll bet.
Beavis.
Prepare your favorite ingredients in the chopper, and you have a picture-perfect breakfast in just minutes.
I want the tasty of that blonde dad. You get
for the amazing low price of just
$40. I'm saving cooking activities.
With tips and mouth-watering recipes, plus this terrific space-saving set of three adjustable spoons.
Three and adjustable no less. Not just convenient, but easy.
But never a hander. This is a Braun. Order
is this
now.
Vibrator repair?
Your Braun Slimline hand blender. Have your crest and
very convenient and very easy.
All for just $4.95 plus $5.95 shipping and handling.
Run to the phone, pick up and dial.
Been making fresh, wholesome food for your baby with the Braun hand blender.
Bullshit. Stop the insanity.
You can see it on her shirt that she's bent over.
Yeah, but there's nothing there.
She's like a rabid Sinead O'Connor.
Look like this. I never learned what the fridge to eat. It's what I eat, the chair.
It's Brett Van Fleet. So that's the shitter. So that's what he's doing lately.
Bert
Nipplehead. Why is your hair like that?
I don't know, but Jeff Larson should tell us how.
Well, what happened, see, was she worked with Karen Silkwood at the power plant there, and she was one of the people that got the shaft in that deal, you know, and you'll notice that her hair glows. It's yellow. She's from, you know, Three Mile Island, where the baseball team, they don't have any lights because the home team grows in the dark, you know what I'm saying?
Fat grams times nine. Oh, what was that? It's dead bear. Oh, dead bear. Oh, oh. Once again, an exciting episode in the adventures of Dead Bear. Taking the pop quiz. Mike Adams pop quiz. The Howard Green question, it looks like, to go for the green question. It is the go for the green question on Mike Adams Sports World.
Howard Green loves to help people with their...
What does he like to help them with, Dan?
Three.
Their hangnails. Hangnails?
Oh, he won the hangnail question.
Do your dance, do it.
Butt shaker. It's like Tyler. Where's that hat, Dan? Take that hat off, boy.
And the home
of the sucky Atlanta Braves.
It's Meatloaf.
Sung by a piece of fucking meat.
Well, I spoke to Don Mattingly the other day, yesterday, as a matter of fact, on
he's
the phone.
He's old.
So, what do you call him, Mr. Loaf?
He said to me,
Chunky Butt White.
But that's certainly not what I was.
Who the hell is that dude?
Secretary of Defense.
It is from the crypt.
He looks like him.
Doesn't he? He's moonlighting as Bobby Inman, former Secretary of Defense nominee there, guy. And not only is on HBO, but he's on C-SPAN. The episode of The Adventures of Dead Bear. Bitch. That's right, long exhausting days of telling the troops that they're not worth the cents God gave the average freaking yak. It's just simply no excuse for any kind of behavior from anyone in the Fonda family. What would Mr. Roberts say, you lying sack of shit? You promised me that you'll flee the country and take that asshole Ted Turner with you.
Old women shouldn't wear like clothes like that.
I know, because
her breasts sag down to her feet.
You can.
It's not very attractive.
You can.
How old is she? 60?
I think so. You know, I think I'd blow Ted Turner for plot seats at a Braves game, wouldn't you?
Oh yeah.
La. Hi, Morgan.
She has like breasts.
My boyfriend. He loves my new smile.
Well, her boyfriend. Is that your boyfriend?
My teeth are whiter after the first time I used it.
Dental White penetrates into the pores of your teeth to lift out grime.
Just paint it right on. See these?
Them chops is happening.
Stick that white paint right on, you city fuckers.
Any episode in the life and death of Dead Bear. What the hell is this? Hey, it's the Insane in the Membrane guys. I think they're called Cypress Hill or Citrus Hill.
Citrus Hill. They also make orange juice.
With no chunky bits, might I add. Someone has a leaky faucet. Hey, it's that Bono guy. You know what? He looks like the leader of the House of Pain. Don't say no shit, don't keep talking like that. Don't blow in my ear. Whoa, it's the automatic rear groper. Do you have that feature in your car? He's kind of proficient. Maybe he's doing that himself. You know who it is? It's Whoopi Goldberg. Oh, do that again, dude.
Talented.
Excellent. Oh, man, yeah. Because first you have a guy blows smoke in your ear. Someone feeds you something. A little black kid gives you a massage. Two chicks kiss you. Some kid smacks you. And then someone cuts your shirt off. Oh my goodness. I can understand why House of Pain is pissed. Wow, now they're mummifying him. Oh my god. Dan? Are you under there? Boy, that's just wacky behavior.
Bono.
Wow. Oh, then someone pushes him down. That's the last straw. Episode of Dead Bear awaits you.
You'll be looking good as new, you filthy animal. Mm. press your ass.
Oh, the chick. We're gonna find the chick here. We've accessed crying. Dan, is this chick hot or what? That chick. Get that zit. There you go. Come on, quit fooling around and make the chick. Ew, he looks like the Who's Tommy. Nah. There, now he looks like the Who's Tommy. Just pass it. That would make it a knee slapper. Oh, access granted. I would love to hear those two words from that wonderful doll. Would you or what?
They're like 90 years old. They're blue.
Come on, show her, you fools.
Hey.
There she is, dude. Whoa. She's amazing. Ah! Come on, cut to the chase. You know we want the amazing crying chick. I don't want to see... Oh, jeez. Watch her work. Damn. Jeez. Wow. Oh.
Oh, God, that's...
Because you dropped a Diet Pepsi on your terminal?
Never jerk off on your terminal. It's not good.
Well, I see what you're saying.
That's expensive equipment.
You're telling me. Exciting and fulfilling episode of Dead Bear.
Through it.
Never was one that really wanted to pick up a pen and write everything, and I couldn't really force myself to do it, so now I have a camcorder, and I'm going to put it to good use, because I think I need to start looking a little bit at myself and how I feel. And a lot of times when you work things out and you talk to someone, even if it's no one, maybe it's to yourself, you can work things out and see that maybe if you have a problem or something, then it's not as bad as it might seem. I don't know. Right now, I feel really... I don't know what the word is. Lost, kind of. Right now, academically, I'm just coming off probably one of the worst semesters I've ever had and probably ever will have. Health-wise, I haven't been doing that great either. I'm on the rise, hopefully in both of those categories. Financially, I'm strapped. And in terms of a relationship, I'm in the dark. So, I'm kind of in limbo. everywhere. That kind of, kind of hard to put a, you know, title on. Really. And a lot of the things that attract me to her, you can't put a finger on, like I said before. Like, well, right now, I don't have the date on, but it's the 25th. It's Tuesday the 25th of January, 1994. And last night, I had an audition for Look Homeward Angel here at school, and that's the new, that's the play that's coming up. And she's very supportive. Very supportive. As a matter of fact, I had about 45 minutes to get ready for the audition, and she called me. And she says, good luck, and blah, 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 and this and that. And I was like, thanks a lot, you know. And so I was just about to go back in the shower. The phone rings again. And I come back out here, and it's her, and she says that she wanted to give me something. A good luck charm of hers, like a little medal that she wears everywhere. And so I took it with me. Still got it. All right. Okay. Get a little tighter on this. I don't know if you can see this, but. So, give me that medal, and, I was flattered and happy, and she cared. I turn my head, it's going like this. I went in and my monologue went very well, and because I had someone to do it for. I had someone to want to do well for. Not just myself, her. I wanted to make her proud of me. And so I went in and did it. And then I was there for like 5 hours, which was a pain in the ass. I was there from like 6:30 to 11:30. So I come back out and I figured I'd go visit her. And I went up to her room. And there was like a little dim light on. I didn't know if it was, if she was in there or if Greg and Danielle were in there, which probably would have been kind of awkward. Hello. That's why I knocked real lightly. And I heard someone say hello in there. Come on in. And I came in. And she was sitting there on Danielle's bed, which is right next to her window. And she had a candle on the windowsill. And it was lit, and she was just sitting there, bathed in candlelight. It just, I don't know how to describe it. The light hit every tint, every spot, every highlight of her face was brought right out. She looked so beautiful. It's unbelievable. Almost jaw almost hit the floor. I did one of the Tom and Jerry things, you know, where his eyes go out of his head, you know, stuff like that. And he goes, but I did it quietly. So I couldn't get over it. And she just looked so perfect that I didn't want anything to change. I didn't want it to end. I just wanted to be able to sit there and look at her. It's almost like you wanted to be able to take life's little pause button here and just, you know, hold everything like that. Just for as long as you can. That's one of the moments that you don't forget, whether you're like 50 or you're like you know, 10, you just carry that with you. It's an image, it's an impression, and it stays. That I'm making right now, I think it's far more interesting and far more complex than, say, Doogie Howser's. Okay, because that kid, he's too simple. I mean, each diary entry is one line.
Today, I learned that it's wrong to,
I don't know, shave the patient's face before trying to take his appendix out. Something stupid like that. But if anyone else is watching this, and I don't think there will be anyone else watching this, at least if they have turned it on, they'll be like, oh, that's Scott's tape, you know, the one where he egotistically talks to himself about himself. We better turn this one off. I just don't know how I feel right now. I'm finding right now that life for me is just plodding along. You know, it's just at a very slow, and I mean, I, you know, if I was in a great mood, maybe it would fly by, probably would, but it's just moving along real slow, and I don't know where I fit into everything, and I just feel like I'm in limbo, like I said numerous times before. And I just, I want what I want, you know? Everyone does. You can't deny it. I mean, I want it my way. And that's, everybody wants that. This is really pensive and kind of depressing, but it's a diary entry, man. You know what she said last night? Here we go again. She said that if I ever went out with anyone else, at this point, right now, since I'm one of her best friends, if I went out with some other girl, she'd be devastated. Why? I don't understand that. I mean, I do understand that, and I, you know, but, well, no, I don't. And it's really hard. It's like, you know, what it says to me, it's kind of like she's on the fence. And I'm waiting for her to fall one way or the other, you know? I'm not gonna say it doesn't matter which side she falls on, because we all know, and everyone playing at home knows which side I want her to fall on, you know? The Scotto side. But I don't know what it is about love that's so hard. I don't mean like to fall into and stuff. I mean, it just is hard. You open yourself up. And me, I do it a lot. And I do it very easily. Sometimes. And I can't play those games that people play about, you know, how they, want to hide, you know, I don't want them to think that I think this, even though I do. I can't do that. I mean, last night I was sitting right up there with her, looking at her in the candlelight like I just described before I went like that, and I just flat out told her, Megan, I love you. Came spilling right out, and it even came out the night before when I had like 9 beers and she called me on the phone, and I was like trying to censor myself, and I said, that's one of the reasons I love you. Oh, damn it, you know, that's what I said, but last night, it just came out perfect. And Megan, if you're watching this, I wish you could give something back to me, like, you know? I mean, I know you have, and I know you are. On a different level, right? You're down here, I'm here. I know you have. If I had one wish right now, it would be that. But remember,
you cannot make people fall in love with you.
He also can't raise people from the dead, because it's really gross and I don't like to do it. Nobody mentioned to me what I should do about it. They said something like, why don't you try and, like, see other girls, right? And then see what Megan's reaction would be to that. I said, no way. No way. First off, if I did that, I'd be lying, and I'd be an asshole. And second off, I don't want anything else. At this point, nothing. Alright, maybe a roll on the Comfort Angel, but aside from that, alright, maybe I do want like a 4-0, but okay, 2-9. I just want to pass. Make my parents happy. Join the Navy. That's what I want. And I would never treat Megan badly, ever. I'd never do anything to harm her. And if anyone ever did do anything to harm her, look out. Because that's just the way I feel about it. Being in love with somebody is kind of like, well, it's kind of like a roller coaster. I mean, it's a roller coaster after you get involved with someone and they're involved with you. You know, you go through all your ups and downs and stuff. But right now, it's like a roller coaster too, because I mean, my emotions go from here to here. So I'll be like, you know, Mr. I'm singing the blues. To something like this. I talk to you. I mean, I could be elated, I could be so depressed that, well, you see the razor blade like this part. I don't think so. Or I could staple my nostrils together and wait until I suffocate. It might be a couple of years. You know, life's weird. And it's going to deal you what it's going to deal you. People are going to say no, people are going to say yes, people are going to come in and out of your life. And I'm only 20 years old, you know, and it's not like there's nobody else out there. But I found one. See, what happens is when you fall in love with somebody, you see something so special in somebody that you just want them to know. And you want to do things for them. Because you want their respect, you want their admiration, you want their love in return. So sometimes it doesn't happen exactly the way you want it. Which I guess in the long run I can deal with. But for right now, it's a tough thing to swallow. Till next time.
Everything, all this original stuff, all I am is I'm the alpha. All right, I'm the person who sits there. I learn the lines, I sing them. I learn the songs, I sing them. That's all I do. When I see people, like athletes, doing things, they're actually creating their own destiny. Yeah, they have the framework of something to do. They have a play to run, you know, victory, whatever. And, you know.
Victory play, it don't work.
So, you know, what they do is they're in control of their own destiny. So watching a game is a lot like watching a drama unfold or a play unfold, but the only thing is, no one knows how it's going to come out. And, I don't know, I've always thought that those are the people that I admire because they, you know, they're out there doing, you know, creating something. And it's actually artwork if you want to look at it artistically. Look at the things that Magic Johnson does. Now, Picasso couldn't do that. You know, if he had a brush, and say, you know, the size of this, if it bounced. You know, I don't know what I'm trying to say here. Well, actually, I do, but I just don't know how to say it. But I admire athletes, sometimes actually more than I admire actors and performers. And you're one of them. You're one of them. And because you're right here. And I know you. And you're a good friend. So get out of the dumps. I hope this tape helped you and all, you know, with at least something. And you know, hey, even if it didn't, you made out with a new tape, so you'd, like, tape something over it, like The Simpsons or Geraldo when he asks those people those questions about, like, sex with furniture and what their opinion is. So,
one more question, Mr. Wichmann.
We have time for one more question.
We have time for one more question. He's trying out for the Celtics after this, so we'll have to catch
him. Go ahead.
If someone came up to you and said, I want you to give up acting, performing, singing, dancing, all those things, and you could start for the Wagner basketball team,
I would do it in a second. Might get swatted a couple times. So what? Life will deal with that.
A starring role on Broadway or a starting place in the Celtics?
The Celtics. So, hey, you got a good thing going there. Somebody else really likes, would like to do what you do.
Somebody else really likes what you do, B.
See you later.
Hey, how's it going? This is part two, I guess. Diary entry number two. Let me get that.
Hi, this is Megan Hudson that I'm talking to on the phone here. Yeah, they probably can hear you. So what are you up to? Nah. Yeah, I have it at 7. We just have a read-through, so it might be pretty brief. Read-through, by the way, yeah, I haven't made my announcement yet to myself. I got the role of Ben Gant in the Look Homeward Angel, and get... Hear that? Whoa, cheer in a second. And I get to die. I get to, like, die a really horrible pneumonia death, and my lungs fill up with fluid, and I make this really, really cool sound. So anyway, it shouldn't run too long. Why, you want to go see Philadelphia? Oh, on ABC? Should I watch TGIF on ABC with her? Yeah, sure. I don't know, maybe an hour. Yeah, Trish is long-winded, big time. Well, what are you doing afterwards? Tonight. Are you going to bed early? She has a meet tomorrow. Who's it against? Oh, it's an everybody meet. Everyone meets everybody. You're lucky that you're in it? Who predicts this stuff? Chris Berman of ESPN? Oh, by who? Your coach? Or you?
Well, how about you prove him wrong? Yeah. I spent like the whole day watching, I watched my Larry Bird video earlier. Yeah, I hadn't watched it in a while, so I just popped it in. And I was like all excited, like the stuff was actually really happening for the first time. Whoa, yeah, awesome! I'm jumping up and down in here. You might actually hear him singing. You know, what I really can't stand is I can't stand seeing these goddamn people, these same people in the news over and over and over again. Nancy Kerrigan, yeah, oh, ow, right, why? Right, all that stuff. Tonya Harding, the Menendez brothers, they should lock all those people. Tonya Harding, the Menendez brothers, John Wayne Bobbitt and his scissor happy wife, and, oh Jesus, who else? Heidi Fleiss, Amy Fisher, Joey, and his wife here, Mary Jo. You should take them all, and the Buffalo Bills, and take them all, just throw them in a goddamn pit and lock them up for the next 150 billion years or so. That's right. That's my editorial for the day. So, well, how do I feel? How do I feel? I feel pretty good. You know, I've been hanging out and auditioning and stuff like that, and it's been paying off because I just got the role of Ben Gantt, the 20 pounds underweight, sensitive, funny, overprotective brother of Eugene, the main character played by Jim Quinlan, who has a girlfriend who's actually his girlfriend in the play, for real, really. So I'm kind of happy, as opposed to maybe the last entry that you saw. I was a little depressed at that point because it was like the first day back and I didn't have everything in order, but I got all my courses, everything squared away, and you know, even the Megan thing still stands. I mean, she's still number one, but I haven't really given too much thought, you know, to that lately because of getting that actor mode or whatever, but I don't know, it just, things have been going all right so far. Last night we had a meeting of all the people who were not cast in the show, and, you know, it was all right. People got feedback from about their auditions and stuff, and that was interesting. So, some people were unhappy, some people weren't, some people were glad, some people didn't even want to be there like me, but I wanted to be a positive influence, you know, and so I went. And, you know, but other than that, no real news to report, you know, just, I'm just chilling, like a villain. So tonight is the first read-through of Look Homeward Angel. Promises to be a very good show. It's got, myself, Tim Quinlan, Charlie Seidenberg, Heather Finn, Gio Pecora, Brian Scambotti.
Call now.
And, yeah. It's going to be a fun show. I'm interested in it, looking forward to seeing what happens and things like that. So.
I'm Greg.
Sure.
See that? That's on camera. My God, I can't believe.
Hey, what?
That? Whoa!
Did that again?
Oh. You know, Greg just messed up the entire thing. He just knocked over the chairs and.
Yeah.
And
that was a powerful kick, man. I can't blame you for that.
Yeah. I was this far away.
Back, powerful punch.
That's right. You know. My game is much bigger than I am.
I got your back.
With the camera, that's right.
Okay,
all right. But see, now I'm looking at the TV to see myself. I'm looking, you know, it's like...
And right now, I'm looking at McTeague. And I'm looking at McTeague now, too.
Oh. Shit. Confusing.
Boy, that's odd.
It's easy, though. It gets better.
So, this room is a nice room. We just go out, hang out, do all this bullshit. It's going to get better, though.
is, we're gonna have a couch here soon, hopefully, if my brother will call him back. And, yeah, get some more plants. Oh, by the way,
Master.
Now, I like Danielle very much.
Is that her?
No. This is a. Yes. Yeah. Let me
explain. What apple? Oh, man.
Let me explain myself. See, I asked for a plant for this room, and because as you can see, there's no plant life in here.
And, other than Greg.
Other than me. And so, she goes out and buys this plant the day before she comes back. Now what she does is she puts this plant in a plastic bag and ties it, and there's no air that gets the plant, and of course it dies, it droops. This looks like, actually looks like one of those Japanese kind of trees, you know?
Bonsai!
But still a great plant. I have this emotional
bond.
That's why it's dying, yeah. Anyways, that's the plant story.
This is the skin bracer story. I got it in a travel pack. It means a lot to me.
Yeah, so
this semester is going to be a good semester. We're gonna do all kinds of stuff.
Says to me, I'm going on a diet.
Yeah?
I said, yeah. I said, you're going on a diet? She said, more or less, yeah.
What kind of diet?
She said, you know, she's going on that kind of diet, you know, where she gives up rich foods and poor boyfriends.
Ha!
I tell you, there is no justice.
What kind of diet is that?
What?
What kind of diet is that?
Kind of pushed me out in the cold, mate.
Okay.
Right.
If I switch accents, don't mind me.
Don't worry about it.
If I go to Italian, I go to Russian, German, or Brooklynish, yeah, don't worry about it. Yeah.
This is what we usually do in this room.
Yeah, usually. But see, these are empty right now. Watch. I would laugh if something came out.
Oh, shit.
It would be gloppy and like 9 months old. Exactly. I guess this was, I think this was the first 2 beers that I had here. I'm on 600,000. First week of school, we were on the floor. Yeah, on the floor in the bathroom.
First week of school, Scott took the first night in the bathroom floor, then I took the second night.
Yeah, we sort of spread it off.
Kind of like alternating. You know,
it was kind of, yeah.
We were on this beer Pop-Tart diet. You know, we drank beer, we ate Pop-Tarts, and then puked. It was great. And that's been on the bathroom floor.
Yeah.
But we gave that up.
Just for now. So, I mean, hey.
Hey.
Tonight, maybe. Maybe I'll.
Maybe we'll. Actually, I can't. I would love to, but I have to pick up Danielle. The city.
Women, you know, they get in the way.
You know, women.
Women, they. Exactly. Women.
That's the thing.
You see a woman?
You know what I'm saying?
Drop.
Oh, boy.
Can I ask a question?
The cast of Look Homeward, Angel. I'm gonna put together a whole tape.
We could put it to music and stuff. It'd be really cool.
Sure. Hold on, I'm just gonna. Everybody, just say hi.
Hi.
1994. Super long play record, and here we go. Driver, Stephen Lowell. Yay! And passenger, Chuck Eberle. Yes.
Hold on just a second, it's not in focus yet.
Okay.
We'll take a minute. Alright.
Okay. Alright. Now, we've done this like so many times.
Guide us through it, my friend.
Okay, now we've turned onto Harold Street, Scott.
No, we've turned
on. Not even the best part, though, which means that I have to turn around and go back. So shut that off for a minute.
I'm recording.
I have to get back to Harold now.
We are going back to Harold Street. Going back to Harold Street.
No,
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
I don't freaking think so.
But on Queen Street, too.
Second of all over.
Do you know anybody would want a Queen Street, too?
Come on, man. Let's have at it.
Let's take a look at her backside.
I'm gonna fucking hit the ceiling.
Carries two programs.
God, you said Bashi for us, exactly.
The crossing of the two lines.
Oh no, I am Bashi.
Listen to this.
The recipe this afternoon is for potato.
It keeps slipping in and out of focus. It's fucked up.
Actually, let's we'll put it on auto focus.
It is, Dick.
Well, then keep it on manual and focus it yourself.
No, because that takes too long.
Shit.
Mood music.
Okay, mood music. Me. Oh, come on, it's nowhere, man. There you go. You broke the fucking car. Yeah!
I was so fucking scared.
Holy shit.
Dude, I fucking jumped and landed on the bumper.
We got the light, man. We got the freaking light, the green light. That was fucking awesome.
Oh, well, we got that.
We got the green light. Boom! Oh, beautiful, beautiful work.
Honestly, Scott, I never ran a stop sign before. And I figured, what the hell? I mean, Scott has this new camera and all.
That's right! And it's under warranty, so why not?
And so I fucking kept the gun, jumped at top speed. We were at 70 miles an hour for that one, by the way. And the car, thank you very much. And the car landed on its bumper like
this. Do your dance, Lowell.
With the way the car landed, you could have shot up front.
I almost went through the roof, dude. It's part of your car. I don't know. I might have just popped out of the back seat. Lowell, give me a triumphant sign. Hold on. Put your arms up in the air, babe.
Scott, I had never jumped that sick before, and I'm afraid to say it's probably the last time I'm ever going to do that, until I can pay for the damage on this car. Okay? Until this car is mine, actually. My mom hasn't given it to me yet. If she sees this tape, she never will, but...
I have it, baby.
Neither will the law for that.
But I know, really. We'll be in jail. And,
We'll be in jail, yeah.
I'm... As much as I love the cinematic value of flying off the ground and nearly landing on the front end and flipping head over heels, well... It'll have to be the last time.
For now.
That run, though. I went through the...
This is so we can wipe ourselves out.
Shit.
I'm
freaking my teeth are floating back here, bud.
I was about to recap on the action. Meanwhile, you were sitting in the back. So, I think we'll let you.
I see, there's the roof that I hit right there. Well, all right. That's another exciting episode in the jumping life of Lowell.
Oh,
shit. My ball.
My ball!
Shit.
sunshine he got. Old jam football he got. Longing finger he shoot. Coca-Cola he said, I know you. You know me. One thing I can tell you is you got to be free. Come together. Tell them where we're going.
But I'm still in the Brady Christmas.
Tell the fans at home where we're going, Chuck.
Wrong way.
Crazy.
Get back to production. He's got all the scumbo. He's got all those sideball. Spinal clacking. He's got feet down below his knees. Hold you in.
Stephen Lowell is super, super Dave Osborne.
Well, Mike. Well, Mike. Go first, though.
All right, Scott, can you throw a speedometer?
Get that speedometer.
I gotta sit up straight for this one.
You're in the way of it.
Alright, I'm going. Does that hit you?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll sit back so you can get a clear shot.
Actually, just tell me. Tell me what the how fast we're going, because it's not gonna be able to focus that fast. Hold on, no. Wait, hold on.
Just
give me your hand out of the way.
We're at now this jump is like timid though.
Yeah, but we're at about 65 miles an hour.
No, we're at 70.
70 now. Pull back now.
I usually go from the outside of the
hand. Yeah, they're cheering pointers. Yeah. Fucking pointers. And ladies and gentlemen, we are almost airborne. All right, punch it, Chewy. Woo! Oh shit! Oh, negative. It didn't go in. Just impacted on the surface.
Hold on, wait.
Is there another one? Oh. That was bullshit.
Who farted?
How come we didn't get it?
Well, it doesn't matter because we have the other one, and the other one is what matters.
I had it floored.
So.
I guess.
It's okay.
I guess the magic wasn't there.
And she knows you're not the hurting kind. She says she loves you, and you know that can't be bad. Yes, she loves you. We are definitely stuck now, fucker. Woo! And Steve-O backs it out in one fucking fell swoop. Oh, what's that smell? It's oil! Whoa, man, that's wicked.
Alright, Tommy.
Alright.
I want that Lamont song.
With a love like that, you know you should be glad.
We're going to take our first step.
Take our first street sign?
Whoa.
Fucking Dagobah! You know it. Oh, no, we'll never get the ship out.
That's our next victim. Celtic Place. The Celtic Place sign.
Thank you.
very cold. Oh, shit, the battery's going down.
Is it?
Yeah.
I don't understand why things have to happen the way they happen. I don't understand why people can't love you. When you pour your heart out. I tried so very hard. I haven't gotten anywhere. And I'm very upset. Tonight, she made it perfectly clear that we are to be just friends.
Friends.
I don't understand. What did I do wrong? How did I ruin it? Guess I'll never know. What I want you to know is that I love you, Megan. Always will. Always will. But I'm very hurt. Hurt that things didn't work out the way they should have. Hurt that I had to go through this again. Someone else. That things couldn't work out. The role of friend is very inviting. I'll try to do my best. But it's painful. It's damn painful. I don't know what I keep doing wrong. I open up every pore of my being. I leave nothing to hide. And I still keep getting squashed, run under by the machine that is life. Whoa, how profound that is. Why does it happen that way? I suppose after a few beers, this thing gets kind of melodramatic. But it's kind of the way I feel, so I guess you could call it like some kind of artistic interpretation of, you know, my soul. I don't know. All I do know is this is a major moment. Excuse me. In my life. I really thought things were going to work out with this particular girl, and I suppose if I'm watching this 10, 20, 30 years from now, I guess it doesn't make any difference. You know, maybe things in the long run will turn out well, but let me tell you right now, this here is a reminder of what it is to hurt. A reminder of what it is to have yourself crushed, in a way. I don't know. See, women are weird. I think everyone playing at home realizes how weird they are. They tell you that they wish there was someone who could come away, that could come towards them, near them, to them, who could sweep them off their feet and do all these wonderful things for them. And when that someone finally arrives, they don't want them, or they want them to fill a certain role, and they want the more raucous, riotous, adventurous guy. You know the one I'm talking about. The one that would treat them badly. Oh, man. I'm watching myself right now. Looking at myself, I don't know what I see. I don't like it. Is that me? Is that me I'm looking at? My brow furrowed with concern. Check it out. There's a knot, a groove, a deep one right here. My forehead. Maybe someday someone will come along and it'll make it go away. Won't be there anymore. Won't be concerned about anything. I'd have a better chance of seeing God. These lonely hours where I talk to myself, maybe I'll get a better picture of what life is all about. In retrospect, things make sense. Complete, perfect, clear, unadulterated sense. Hindsight is always the best vision. Perhaps the decisions I make don't mean anything. thinking, if you're watching this ever, anyone makes you take a look at it, it's me or someone else, I want you to know that I see in you a very special thing. It's a special quality of caring. I love you for it. Gotta make sure I'm in the camera here. I would have done anything that you asked. Anything you wanted, I would have gotten. Could have been a good... whatever. I guess life deals you a hand and you're supposed to take it. I don't like the hand it dealt me this time. But there'll be other hands. Doesn't really make sense, does it? Nothing really does. It's just our job to make sense of nothing. Oh, look at me, just drunk enough to make an asshole out of myself in front of me alone. Hopefully these tapes will be valuable someday. Maybe they'll on Geraldo or something stupid. Hi. She walks in beauty. Like the night of cloudless climes and starry skies. And all that's best of dark and bright meet in her aspect and her eyes. Thus mellowed to their tender light which heaven to gaudy day denies. One shade the more, one ray the less. Half impaired the nameless grace which waves in every raven tress, or softly lightens o'er her face, where thoughts, serenely sweet, express how pure, how dear their dwelling place. And on that cheek, and o'er that brow, so soft, so calm, yet eloquent, the smiles that win, the tints that glow, but till of days and goodness spent, a mind at peace with all below, a heart whose love is innocent. Things to each other. We find ourselves vulnerable, very vulnerable. And ourselves. Someday I'll find someone. Someone who will be as good to me as perhaps Dina was. If I do, I won't blow it like I blew the other one. It hurts so bad to look at myself. But I can do it. Because I know I'm worth it. And I can make a difference in someone's life someday. And I can make them a happy person. I won't rest until that's the case. This is what life is all about. Living, loving, trying to protect your heart from love, which gives and takes. I just slipped into a coffee accident. But she makes me happy to be alive. The day after. Aha! How'd I feel? Well, I don't feel drunk anymore. I don't feel particularly triumphant, though. Hold on. So here I am, in all my glory, all my splendor. Not drunk anymore.
Yeah, hello.
There's no candle. There's no bullshit.
How are you doing?
And
is this great?
I'm gonna try and...
Scott!
Sure. Oh, sure. So you
know, try and do...
I'll say man. No.
Running thing.
Yeah? Of course. Yep, I didn't use my crutches today. I'm walking with them. No. I went to the trainers. I just got back. And I put my leg in the whirlpool.
Put his leg in the whirlpool.
Wants to make come back tomorrow.
Wants to come back later.
So. Alright, yeah. I told him to go black and blue around the toes because it is. He's like, that's to be expected. So.
Well.
I'm like, well, it didn't happen.
Nothing
before.
New to report at this time.
Got me. Hold on.
I got my own.
Check it out, babe. Just got this in the mail.
Hey. You don't have to do it no more.
Navy booklet. Today's Navy. Pretty cool.
So, you always want to hear something funny? Scott and I were in anthropology class, and we're looking at the boy, and this Bolton boy has all this, like, Cancun spring break and, you know, European trips and stuff like that. And
you're
he,
right.
You know, come study across the sea.
Kyrgyzstan.
And Scott was like, I just gotta get out of here. I would love to go on one of those things, you know, go on a boat somewhere and see something like that, right? So we go to his mailbox for lunch after class, and he gets this, Today's Navy, you know, brochure in the mail. And it was so funny. He's like, holy shit, is this a sign of what? He goes, last night, everything was in the line with Megan, and now today I'm talking about going overseas and trying to get this Today's Navy. That's the sign I'm going.
I'm as good as a seaman. I'm as good as seaman.
I'm a good scene.
Well, we'll see what happens. Whether I become one of these here.
That was really funny. We're going through the whole brochure making fun of everyone because they look like they're all posing. Not knowing what the
they
heck
are all posing.
Now.
They're like,
I think if they just put
maybe
a model off the street, like, oh, son. What are your measurements? You know, they like to give me a
phone
now.
Hey.
They look like you know what you're doing. Smile. Pretty.
Ooh, it works.
Good. You know?
So. I'll be a Navy guy.
So, did you just get up? Yeah, because I didn't see you at lunch. I figured, you know, you're going to go. I'm hoping to see you.
Al?
Why, Al? It's Al.
I will survive.
I think I'm Al.
You better fucking believe it.
You gonna watch now? What's now? Oh.
Well. Nothing new to report today, really. Just on the rebound.
What?
Well, actually, I'm probably gonna go watch Star Wars with him tonight or something neat like that.
Because
I'm a charming, friendly kind of guy who can't say no and hurts himself as a matter of course.
So you wanted to get your homework done today, so you can do it tonight.
Nice. No, I have rehearsal tonight. Don't worry. I'll just have to take some haircuts. Watch.
I wanted to get the island town. But Chuck and I have a family.
Oh.
I don't know.
What?
You want to see me back?
I will survive. And
okay.
This is me.
Oh, ask Chuck. Ask around. Actually, I want to go to Chuck. You know what? When you go over to Gary's meeting, can you slip over here and just pick up a page? A white tape I want you to give to Chip, but if you take the old gun for me. Alright, just hand it to him. He's there, he's not there. Yeah, I have two tapes, so. Yeah, I'll do that. What two shows do I want to do? Okay.
Chuck,
hey, how you doing? It's a pretty tough guy. Come on, get the camera.
You!
Smokey, wah, bah.
Oh, wah.
We just got done watching the chorus line. It was very good. Except that Chip Scott cut the ending completely off, so we did not get to see the whole chorus line, which is what the whole show was about. The very end of the chorus line.
But you saw me.
But we saw a split second of Maggie, yes.
Stupendous.
It was just wonderful. It was excellent. She was very good. Very good. I applaud her. You were wonderful. Great job. She's very late, retired. So, we normally would do one of those videos where we're kind of naked and making whoopee, those kind of videos, but we decided not to, so we're kind of tired. Maybe next time.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. So.
Constitutes a neighborhood. I originally put these sweats on because they weren't dirty. But here we go again. Okay, here's the scenario. Suns are down by one. Danny Ainge gets it in the perimeter with 2 seconds left. Goes to Ainge. 3, 2, and...
Yeah!
Modest. Larry Bird has to make one to win it for the Celtics. It's all over. It's all over.
Wichmann on the break. He comes in. Here's the Dipsy Do. Yes! Unbelievable!
See, that's the Dipsy Do move. And I probably look really awkward on it, but... Doesn't matter.
The bank shot. Yes! Crowd goes nuts. Unbelievable.
I hope.
Thank you.
Oh, this light kills the battery big time.
Right here. Let's go. Come on, try and get a shot off. Try and get a shot off. Come on, nothing's coming through here. I'm a brick wall. I'm John Casey, the Boston Bruins. See?
Pour like- milk on the kitty. Don't do that. Hey! Say hi, Megan. He's pouring milk on the cat. What does he have on his head?
Wet.
He's all wet.
More.
No, don't. Hey, Bradley, don't do that. Don't touch it. Give him a chip. Give him a pretzel. See the pretzel on the... See the pretzel?
Hi.
Give him a pretzel. Say Hey Bradley. Hey Bradley. 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 Brad.
Hi.
Hi.
This your tunnel? What's your name?
Bradley.
Bradley?
That's my oldest.
How old are you?
Two.
Can you say whoa? Whoa!
Oh. Any kind of tape in there?
What?
Can you put any kind of tape in there?
No, it's just a small... Ah, geez, my hair is all staticky now. Come here. Come on in. Nice. Come here. Hey, you, come here! Oh. Oh! Ow! Ah! Come here. Hey, Bradley. Come here.
Bradley. Hey. Shoot the rock. Shoot the ball. Come on. Let's go, Larry. Oh, shoot. Here you go. This thing. Oh. Here, go ahead. Get it. Go get the ball.
I guess I'm asleep.
Oh, geez. Actually, he takes after someone in the beginning of this tape, doesn't he? With all his misses, but it's all right.
My husband.
Hey, get the ball.
And my baby.
Oh. Did it go in the tunnel? Hey, Bradley, jump off. Yay! Spider-Man. Go get it. Bradley's now entering the Cave of Doom. Mm-hmm. Now put it up. Put it up right there. No, don't get on there. Just put it up from here. Just put it up. Shoot it. Come on, you're not going to be able to play ball on the step. All right. Go ahead, take it. Bird for three. Shoot it.
Isn't this
almost, bud. He was hitting everything the other day. Trust me, shoot it. Look at the basket. Look up here.
Yeah, that's right. How far is
here you go.
General Oh, he wants
popcorn. Hey. Look.
40 miles.
Watch left handed.
Now listen, gentlemen.
Bang!
San Carlos.
You say bang?
Not a puppet of the United States. Do you understand that? Right, you will stay within the corridor.
Shoot it!
Fine by precedent, I've got that.
Oh.
Is that clear? No.
Oh. Oh, and there it is.
All right.
Okay, take the shot. Hey, Brad. Watch this. Left-handed.
Sit down.
Oh. No way.
Bradley, come on, get down.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, buddy.
Of
Here, set me five. Here, let me give you five. Down low. Hey! I'm gonna follow you in there.
There will be.
Look out, watch. Hey, buddy. Down.
Up and down.
Up and down. Go up. Up.
General.
Down.
BA.
Down.
What about Colonel McCoy?
Hey, Bradley. Bradley, watch. Watch. Psycho monster.
Mama. Mama.
What?
Hi. Mama.
Say, hey, hey. Who's that? Who's that? Go get him. Say hi, kitty.
Hi.
That cat is a jerk. That cat has hated me since you've had it. I hate him.
Mama.
Hey, Brad basketball. Come here. Come on. Come on. Come on, shoot the rock. I didn't say take a bite out of it. You. Oh. No, not at me. It's not. No, up here. Hey. Get away from that. Get away from that, you terror. Now shoot the ball. Kitty. Hey, Brad. Who's that? Who's that?
The ball.
Give a kitty the ball.
Over the countryside, as the king maker, his captain of the guard, a ruthless and greedy man.
Ooh, the prince and the pauper is on. Bradley, come here, look.
What's the meaning of this outrage? Even the lowliest subjects of this kingdom deserve respect. Have him brought to me at once.
Hey, bud. No, is that full?
Prince wishes to see you.
That's full.
Allow me.
Who's that?
Let me know. It's your idea of humor.
Look. You do look like me. Hey, Bradley. You look like me. Here we go. I'm gonna stick it on your head. Watch, watch, watch. Here, here. Here, get in it. Get in it.
Saving your life. I was about to die of boredom when you interrupted my lesson. Do you know what it's like to be the prince?
Oh, do you know what it's like to be the prince? Do you?
And every night the banquet after feast. Wow. And then 9 o'clock, bedtime.
Moo.
All day long.
Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? The elusive Bradley Wheat. What's up, Chief?
Oh, if I could take your place for just one day.
Whatever for?
Yes. Grand idea. Don't you see?
Again.
Bye, man.